Hello, everyone, wherever you may be, and thank you so much for tuning in to another edition of Miami Women's Basketball here on RedHawk Radio. It's a good one tonight. It is the Miami RedHawks taking on the Loyola Ramblers from Chicago. Now, coming into this game, Miami versus Loyola all-time series. Loyola has won both games, so Miami losing all-time series 0-2, but they were pretty competitive games, no question about it. First game in 1984, Loyola won by 20, 84-63. They won by 21 there. And in the second one, they played last year actually in Chicago, and Loyola won that one 69-52 in 2021. So Loyola Ramblers, they're trying for a third straight win against the RedHawks, and otherwise they really haven't met. Geographically, definitely close, but haven't really met, haven't really played very often, so should be a good one. Now, coming this year, the Miami RedHawks, they're 1-4 overall. They haven't played any MAC games, but overall, they're 10th out of 12 in the Mid-American Conference. Now, last game against Evansville, a team ranked to finish 9th out of 12th in the Missouri Valley Conference. They lost that one 97-72. Really a 25-point blowout at Millett Hall a few days ago, so not a very good showing, but here are some players that really showed out for the RedHawks. Number four, Ivy Wolf, the sophomore sharpshooter in 39 minutes. That, for any of you back at home wondering about the quick math, that's basically the entire game. She played all but 1 minute in that affair, and she scored 23 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists, 2 steals, 1 block, and overall shot 9 for 25 from the field, 3 for 10 from 3. So she made 3 three-pointers, and she made both of her free throws. And she really knocked down all 5 stats in each stat column. But overall, it was kind of an inefficient showing, inefficient shooting against Evansville. But she did rack up 23 points. She's going to be for sure a threat in this one. Very dangerous player. Look out for her. She's number 7 in the MAC in scoring, and number 2 in the MAC in steals, and number 5 in assists. So overall, really dangerous player. Really, if you're on defense, you got to keep an eye on her because Ivy Wolf plays her heart out. Another player who played well last game against Evansville, number 1, Maddie Kluse, the sophomore floor general. In 25 minutes, she scored 22 points, 5 rebounds, 2 offensive rebounds, 3 assists, 3 steals, and a much more efficient shooting performance. She shot 8 for 17, 3 for 7 from 3, so she made 3 threes in that one, and 3 for 5 from the free throw line. Overall, a very good game and played extremely efficient. And just for just a heads up right now, Maddie Kluse, number 1 in the MAC in scoring, so she is for sure going to be a factor in this one. Look out for her. Both her and Ivy Wolf, the dynamic duo, as I like to call them, they're going to be for sure a factor in this one. Both playing extremely well. She's also number 8 in the MAC in rebounding and number 4 in the MAC in steals. So Ivy Wolf and Maddie Kluse both can do it all. All facets of the floor, they get it done. No question about it. Claire Chambers, number 0, the sophomore Energizer Bunny in 34 minutes. Really played mostly the entire game. 9 points, 1 rebound, 3 assists, 1 steal. Overall, she did a great job. She played defense, and good performance by her. But really, the story of this game is going to be number 24, the senior superstar Peyton Scott coming back. This is going to be her third game since having that injury last year. Overall, expect to see a much bigger performance. Last game, she had 15 minutes. Second game back from her injury, this will be her third tonight. In 15 minutes, 4 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, and 1 steal. So expect some big things from her. Last year, she averaged 19 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists, and 2 steals. So expect some big things from her. The MAC All-Freshman team in 2019 and second team All-MAC in 2020 and 2021. So really, the sky is the limit for Peyton Scott. We will see what she has in store for the Loyola Ramblers, because we know they got to get ready for this really big three, really talented big three of Wolf, Scott, and Kluse. Imani Freeman also played well. in 16 minutes. 6 points, two rebounds, one assist, and one block. Really strong forward for the Miami RedHawks. She's going to be a presence in this one, no question about it. She did her job. And Sierra Morrow, the forward slash center, the junior, 6'1 in 22 minutes, 4 points, one rebound, one assist, and one block. She is 10th in the MAC in blocks. So just like Freeman, they're both going to be a presence, definitely a force in this one. Look out for them on the defensive end, no question about it. Now, overall, in the affair against Evansville, they shot 40% from the field, 32% from three, and 67% from the free throw line. So overall, you really got to have smarter shots and got to knock down threes, especially in crunch time. And they got out-rebounded by 17, so you got to step it up in all facets of the game. And what a great chance against the Loyola Ramblers, a team that's pretty similar to the RedHawks. Coming in this year, the Loyola Ramblers, they're 2-4 overall. 11th out of 15th in the Atlantic 10 division. And last game, they played against St. Francis from Pennsylvania, the Red Flashes, and they won 69-56, so a solid 13-point win at home. Played pretty well at the Gentile Arena in Chicago. Number 14, Sophia Nolan, she played extremely well. The dominant paint force in 28 minutes. She had 18 points, 2 rebounds, 1 assist, 3 steals, while shooting 6 for 9 from the field, 1 for 2 from 3, and she made all 5 of her free throws. So very efficient and effective against the Red Flashes of St. Francis, and she really can score from anywhere. So RedHawks got her hands full with her, no question about it. Number 10, Maya Chandler, the junior floor general, in 27 minutes, 12 points, 4 rebounds, 1 steal, and she made all 3 of her free throws. So also extremely efficient and can do damage anywhere. Number 14 in the Atlantic 10 division in scoring, averaging 14 points, 4 rebounds, 1 assist, 2 steals, and she's shooting really efficient. And she is the 2020 Missouri Valley Conference Freshman of the Year. So overall, two very talented players, no question about it. Another player the RedHawks should look out for, number 12, Sam Galanpalos, the senior, who is number 7 in the Atlantic 10 in assists, very crafty guard, and can dish the ball to anyone, anytime, so super dangerous player. All three of those players are going to be a challenge for the RedHawks, no question about it. Now, overall, the RedHawks, the Ramblers, shot 47% from the field, 57% from three, 87% from the free throw line, incredibly efficient, especially the charity stripe. And we'll take a quick break with the national anthem. Don't go anywhere. It's Miami Women's Basketball here on Red Hawk Radio. Welcome back to Millett Hall. It's Miami Loyola kicking off in just a few short moments. Miami and Loyola, very similar records, very similar teams. Miami, a little bit more guard heavy with Ivy Wolf, Maddie Kluse, and Peyton Scott, all three of them guards. Expect great things from them, especially Peyton Scott, who without a question is going to step it up. 15 minutes in her last game, she is for sure going to have a bigger role. And for the Loyola Ramblers, expect some things from Sophia Nolan, the 6'1 senior, who's going to play extremely well. She played well last game, and expect some similar things from her. Maya Chandler, the guard for General, as I like to call her, 12 points in her last matchup. Expect similar things from her. And Anna Brown, 22 minutes last game, 8 points, 1 rebound, 1 assist. So overall, 3 very talented players, but the RedHawks also have some players that can do it all off the bench. Jessie Dye, we've seen her step it up in previous games, as well as Katie Richardson. So overall, some very well-rounded teams, 2 very evenly matched teams on both sides of the floor. We'll see what happens here at Millett Hall. Now, there's no top 25 games going on tonight, but I will take you over to a scoreboard segment, checking out the games at on tap tonight. So the lone top 25 matchup is going to be Maine against Gonzaga and in Spokane, Washington, so that should be a good one. Gonzaga, 23rd ranked team in the nation. They're 5-1 overall, and they're playing Maine, who are coming in to visit. It's going to start off at 9 o'clock Eastern time, so 6 o'clock Western time. That's when it starts, and overall should be a good one. Campbell and Norfolk State are kicking off now. Campbell currently down by 5, 31-36, so that already is a fun one. Western Carolina against UNC Asheville. That is squared at 16 apiece at the end of the first game, so another very competitive game. Southern Wesleyan against Wofford at Wofford. That game kicks off at 7 o'clock p.m. Should be a fun one. Pfeiffer against Furman at Furman. Game starts at 7 o'clock. That also should be another fun one. Another MAC team in Bowling Green. They're hosting the Detroit Mercy. That game starts off at 7 o'clock. Akron on the road against Northern Kentucky. That should be a fun one as well. Starts off at 7. Wright State against Eastern Illinois at Eastern Illinois. That game starts off at 7. Brown against Central Connecticut. That game starts off at 7 as well. This game, Loyola versus Miami, going to be a fun one, no question about it. That game kicks off in about a few minutes. Texas Southern against Ole Miss. That is going to be a fun one, a good SEC team in the Ole Miss Rebels, 5-1 on the year. 3-0 at home. Can they make it a fourth win at home? We shall see. That game starts off at 7 o'clock. Texas Southern against Ole Miss. Central Christian College against Oral Roberts. We'll see what happens there. In Oklahoma, game starts at 8 o'clock here. We already talked about the main Gonzaga game. Pepperdine against Cal State Fullerton. That's going to be a fun West Coast California matchup right there. That game kicks off at 10 o'clock. Cal State Fullerton. Titans taking on the Pepperdine Waves. That one starts off at 10 o'clock. South Dakota State Jackrabbits are taking on the Washington State Cougars at 10 o'clock in Pullman. So that is another late game, but that's going to be a fun one, no question about it. And that was a scoreboard segment. Keep you guys updated as we go on in this broadcast. But overall, we've got ourselves a good one here. Loyola versus Miami, 2 very similar teams. It'll be interesting to see what we have in store. It'll be interesting to see what Peyton Scott is going to bring to the table. Superstar senior, as I like to call her. She should be able to go off. She should have a lot more opportunities with minutes restrictions, kind of a thing of the past now. She already has a couple games under her belt, so expect some things from Peyton Scott and that big 3 for Miami. Now the RedHawks, keys to the game. You got to get it to Maddie Kloos because she will be able to make those shots. Number 1 scorer in the MAC. Look out for her. Also another thing, let Ivy Wolf cook because she is one of the top assisters in the MAC. Look out for her because she will be able to dish it. And if it's in her hands, the RedHawks will be able to make shots. And you gotta let Matt, you gotta let Peyton Scott get into the groove, and it's pretty much a done deal. So overall, a pretty young and athletic team, and they will make plays, no question about it. Really well-coached teams on both sides of the floor. It's Miami versus Loyola, and now I'll be sending it off to both of our announcers, Patrick Geshan and Patrick Holland, with the call tonight.
Thank you, Andrew, very much. Great job on the pregame, as always. We welcome you inside Millett Hall here in Oxford, Ohio tonight. It is the Miami RedHawks. It is the Loyola Chicago Ramblers on the floor this evening in women's basketball action. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland are with you tonight here on Red Hawk Radio. And Patrick, Andrew set up the matchup really well there, talking about the storylines coming in. You have Loyola Chicago, a team that's 2-4 overall coming into this matchup. They're trying to find their winning ways this season. Same thing for the Red Hawks, who are 1-4 overall. Each team offensively hasn't really performed to their best ability so far this season. And it's just kind of that time of year when you start to figure out who you are and try to put together some good basketball here down the stretch as the calendar turns to December.
Right, Patrick. Yeah, I think it's early. Yeah, we're early today. Early in the season, Patrick. I wouldn't, you know, if you're Coach Hendricks, I wouldn't hit the panic button on anything just yet. You know, the last three results, you haven't got what you wanted. You know, they've been a little bit, they've gotten out of hand for you. But I think this is a great chance for you to flip the script, right? You tell the team, you know, we're back in Millett Hall. You know, we got a lot of people here, a good environment for the team. So, you know, and again, you've got great performances in your last game. You know, you got two young players in Ivy Wolf and Maddie Kloss who both combined for 45 points. You know, it wasn't enough ultimately, but I think tonight is a great chance to go back to doing the little things right. You know, closing out on defenders, hustling for loose balls. You know, we see on the back of their warm-up shirt that says the word grit, right? So I think for Coach Hendricks, that's going to be a key word for this team is be gritty, be tough, die for loose balls. I think if I'm Coach Hendricks, I want to see a lot of that tonight from the girls.
Yeah, she is a process-oriented coach. One of the things she mentions most to her team is that grit and the toughness throughout the season. Peyton Scott, obviously a big storyline coming into this game, the Red Hawks star player who missed the beginning of the season due to an injury. Two appearances under her belt this season. She has not started a game yet, coming off the bench, playing a few minutes, had 15 minutes against Evansville in the Red Hawks last game where she scored 4 points. Trying to get her back and healthy is just such an understated huge part of this Red Hawks team and their success this season.
Yeah, right. I don't even think it's, you know, the scoring. I think all that's going to come. The time on the court is going to come. But, you know, the emotional, you know, having a top 10 all-time scorer on your team is a big deal for this program.
Right.
And, you know, that is something you can't really teach. You can't coach if you're Coach Hendricks. You know, having a player like Peyton Scott on the floor is going to be a big impact. And I, like I said, I don't even think it's the much of the scoring. I think it's the emotional impact she brings to the court.
That's true. As a pretty light crowd, it fills into Millett Hall this evening for this game between Miami and Loyola Chicago. These two teams met last year in Chicago, but before that, the last time they saw each other, 1984 in late December, the Ramblers lead the series all time 2-0. We are back with the tip-off in just a moment, but first we'll listen to Scott Shriver, the public address inside Millett Hall for tonight's starting lineups.
Yeah.
So there's a starting lineup for the RedHawks tonight. It is Chambers, Clues, Morrow, Wolf, and Freeman. Loyola Chicago is starting with Chandler, Galanopoulos, Nolan, Tannen, and Brown this evening for the Ramblers inside a light crowd here from Millett Hall. Lights will come up. We'll get ready to go here. Loyola Chicago wearing maroon uniforms tonight. Loyola across the front in gold. A gold number on the front, gold number on the back for the Ramblers. The RedHawks are in their home whites this evening with Miami across the front in red. A red number on the front and a red number on the back for the RedHawks, who will move right to left across your radio here in the first quarter of play. And Patrick, a huge start for the RedHawks to be pretty important here. They've been kind of a slower team to get going in games to start the season off.
Yeah, I think when you also, we looked at the last three games we talked about, you know, you're not getting the results you want, but I think this is an opportunity here. You know, you're back home. I want to see this team come out really fast, you know, get the ball in the hoop early, get that positive momentum starting off right off the bat. I think it's the best way to start.
Yep. Teams are on the floor as we start the basketball game. The opening tip-off will be taken by Satori Tannen of Loyola Chicago, 6'2 junior for the RedHawks. It'll be Sierra Morrow, 6'1 junior. The ball is thrown up, the tip won by Loyola Chicago. The game is on from Oxford. Early bobble for it as Anna Brown fell to the floor after collecting the tip-off win. They're going to whistle a foul there against her, and the RedHawks we'll pick it up here with 5 seconds gone by in the opening quarter. Inbound from the near sideline by Maddie Clues to Ivy Wolf. Takes it over the timeline, middle of the floor for the RedHawks. Clues far elbow trying to dish down low to the post area. Went over the head of Amani Freeman, the 6'2 senior, out the baseline, and Loyola Chicago will get it back. Scoreless game, 15 seconds in. Galanopoulos takes it to the right wing for Loyola Chicago. Top of the key with it is Chandler. Dishes back outside, moving her way toward the right side of the paint. Tannen flipped it back. Chandler, the pass went over her arm. Here comes Wolf to the rack, and it's in for two with the right arm for Ivy Wolf. 2-0 RedHawks get the opening bucket of the game.
So far what I'm liking, what I'm seeing, Patrick, is a lot of communication, a lot of people talking to each other, and a lot of great effort.
Chandler with it across the paint for LIU from far to near side. This is out left wing outside the arc with the ball is Galanopoulos. Left side of the paint now with it is Tannen. The free throw line drives down the left side of the paint, floats it off the glass for two. That is good defense from Freeman there in the post, but Loyola Chicago will tie the game up at two. Loose with the ball for the RedHawks over the timeline, middle of the floor with a right-handed dribble. Makes her way around the arc, will dish to the near wing. Outside is Morrow with the ball for the RedHawks. Sierra Morrow, the junior from Minneapolis. Clues top of the key with it, around the arc in the far side. Hit the brakes, goes inside the arc, flips up a jumper that misses left from just inside the line. It heads out of bounds, and Loyola Chicago will get it back. Ramblers inbound the ball from their baseline. Nolan to Galanopoulos over the timeline on the right wing. Back for Nolan, top of the key. Far side, Chandler with it across the paint. Kicks it back out up top. Here's Nolan. Hits the left elbow, flips it outside the arc, left wing to Chandler, right-handed dribble going up against Wolf. Chandler hit the breaks free throw line, this is out right wing, 10 to shoot. Brown will go back to the left wing and a three ball. Chandler with 5 to shoot, that missed short, rebound fought for. RedHawks get it on the far wing, it's close, carrying over the timeline to the right wing. Near side to Chambers, give and go in the corner with Wolf. Top of the key now, close with the ball with the right-handed dribble, walks it back toward the big red M at half court. RedHawks and Loyola Chicago tied at 2 with 7:48 to go in the first quarter. Wolf to the rack with the right arm, and it's good. Off the glass for 2 as she was guarded heavily by Brown, but Wolf won the battle, and the RedHawks lead 4-2. Hardside Loyola Chicago in the offensive end. It's Chandler to the near wing for Brown. From the corner, working Gallinopoulos. Left wing feed for Tannen. Back outside New York, long range three. In and out, wide open there was Gallinopoulos. Rebound RedHawks, it's Chambers who corrals and collects. Flips up left wing for Kloos over the timeline for the RedHawks. Feeds down low toward the paint. Freeman working the back low, but the ball slipped out of her hands right to Chandler of Loyola Chicago. Over the timeline, she'll come on the right wing to the offensive end. Cut across the paint from the near side, flipped it up off the glass too much. On that, Kloos with a rebound for the RedHawks over the timeline left wing. She'll drive her way from the left wing to the right side of the paint. Off the window too much with a right-handed layup attempt. And Loyola Chicago with a board. Gallinopoulos will get the feed from Tannen, who brought it down.
Yeah, we're off to a little bit of a hectic start so far, Patrick. But I think when, you know, Loyola Chicago is playing that 3-2 defense, I think it demands a lot of ball movement, a lot of consistency. You know, the passing is going to come, and that will open up their shots from inside.
Nolan sinks a three for Loyola Chicago, top of the key, and the Ramblers take their first lead of the night at 5-4. 6:30 left, opening corner. Left side of the paint, right back to the ball, offensive end. Kloos spins around and is fouled as she went up against Maya Chandler, the junior from Martinsville, Indiana. It's spin around play there by Kloos, trying to go to the rack from the left side of the paint. And two shots will come for the sophomore of the RedHawks. With 6:26 to go in the opening corner, as Loyola Chicago will make a couple of substitutions here.
Yeah, what? Pretty thing about Ivy Wolf and Kloos so far is they're decisive. You know, they see the opportunity right there and they go right to the basket. That's great to see from an early in the game.
First free throw is good by Kloos, who averages 19.2 points per game this season. Second one a little bit too hard, tipped out of bounds. It's gonna go back to the Ramblers as Freeman was in there, knocked it out for the RedHawks. Kloos leading the team with 19.2 points per game this season. Ivy Wolf second for the RedHawks, 15.8 on the year. So Loyola Chicago with a ball on the offensive end. It's a tie game at 5. Right side of the elbow, Gallinopoulos. Dishes to the far wing, Nolan. Free throw line jumper, too far left to the rim. Peyton Scott is in the game for the RedHawks. He'll flip it up left wing for Ivy Wolf. And a cross-court pass went to the far corner. Sydney Watkins cannot corral it. It was tipped out of bounds by Tannen. Out the far corner from Loyola Chicago, and the ball will stay with Miami. A baseline inbound far side for the RedHawks in their offensive end with 25 to shoot. 6:04 to go in the first. Wolf flips it in toward the paint, trying to hit Freeman with a feed. It was broken up there by Jayla Johnson of the Ramblers. And then she lost it up ahead. Slipped out of her hands as Watkins back to corral for the RedHawks. And their own end, Peyton Scott tries a three, left wing, too much on it. And the rebound here to Tannen, flips up ahead, right side for Chivers. It is Chivers through the lane for Loyola Chicago. She got messed up there, a good defensive block by Watkins. Here's Scott over the timeline, middle of the floor, flips left wing, Wolf a three, and it's good. And the RedHawks take an 8-5 lead with 5.5 to go in the first.
Yeah, Peyton Scott missed the three on the last possession. Ivy Wolf made it there. Those shots are going to be there. Those three-point opportunities, particularly in this 3-2 defense, is going to be there when they move the ball. They just got to keep shooting.
Scott is still at the other end. We'll take it up the right wing for the RedHawks. The layup is good for Peyton Scott to make it 10-5 Miami. A clean steal on the far wing from Tannen. And went coast to coast. Top of the key, Loyola Chicago back with the ball on the offensive end. Tannen drives her way down near side of the paint. Well, kind of hit the brakes, pivot on the right foot. There's good defense, hard defense there by Kloos. Ball goes out left wing, Gallinopoulos. Far corner, Tannen dishes back to the left side of the paint. And traveling after getting the feed was Mallory Ramage for Loyola Chicago. Bigger partner was actually Julia Heffling, who got it. The Cincinnati native out of Mount Notre Dame. 4:54 to go in the first. We have our opening media timeout. 10-5 RedHawks over Loyola Chicago, and this is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland back with you inside Millett Hall. Tonight it's a 10-5 lead for the Miami RedHawks over the Ramblers from Loyola, Chicago with 4:54 to go in quarter number one. And Patrick, so far the RedHawks and the Ramblers pretty even in that first 3 minutes. You could say last 2 minutes though, the RedHawks making a lot of progress on the defensive end of the floor, generating a lot of chances on the offensive end as well. Turnovers generated, and that's why the RedHawks have the largest lead of the game at this point.
Yeah, I think if you're Coach Gianna Hendricks, you know, you got to come out and say, I'm really happy with this team so far. You know, there's been a couple turnovers here and there on the offense side of the ball, but on the defensive side, I love the communication, right? Every girl's talking to each other. They all know what they're doing, making sure they're in communication with one another.
Yep.
That's a big part of playing great defense. So I think great defense, you know, it always does translate to great offense, too. I think it is being seen a little bit on the offense side of the ball right now, too. So I'm, you know, once again, we talked about it coming out here early. You want to see intensity, right? You want to see a lot of girls fighting for loose balls, fighting for the, you know, fighting on the ground for balls, and they're doing a great job so far. It's just, you know, it's maintaining that intensity all throughout a game.
Right, and that's the big problem for the RedHawks. Can they keep it up this year? Maddie Clues to the ball, but a timeout, top of the key for Miami. Dishes left wing for Peyton Scott at the edge of the paint, flipped up a quick shot from 10 feet away, short left wing of the rim. So Chivers back with it up the floor for Loyola Chicago. Her feed to the middle gets tipped off a RedHawk, and it was Watkins who got there. And the Ramblers back with the ball after they walked it on the turnover. Chivers flipped it up off the board too hard. The rebound, though, picked up by Galanopoulos for Loyola Chicago and put it into the hoop for two, and it's 10-7 Miami. 4:14 to go in the first. Scott dishes far away for Ivy Wolf. Down low right side of the paint, working here, Maddie Clues. Step back jumper, too much on it. Rebound picked up by Morrow. She'll finish off the window for two. Really good awareness there by Morrow on the near wing to pick up the two hard shot from Clues.
Yeah, and the other end, Patrick, they let Loyola Chicago get the loose ball that end. They get it and get the 2 points.
And a foul whistle here on the RedHawks. Chivers fell over after contact with Sydney Watkins. Ball fell out of bounds. I don't think they call it a foul. Actually, I think they're just going to give the ball back to Loyola Chicago. So Watkins made contact there. Quick feed inside, right side of the paint. Nolan flips it up. The shot's good, but she's whistled for a travel. A step too many there in the paint, trying to drive her way to the hoop from a few feet away. And the RedHawks inbound here after the turnover from the Ramblers. Loose over the timeline left wing. 3:45 to go. First quarter, 12-7 RedHawk lead. Top of the key with it, Scott flips it in from the three-point land, too hard. But the rebound for the RedHawks on the offensive end of the floor. Wolf left wing will try a three, that's short. Scott swoops in for the rebound. Left edge of the paint, goes down low, wide open to the post, and in for two off the window. Sierra Morrow with both arms. Really good passing and awareness there for the RedHawks to generate 2 points.
Sierra Morrow, it was nothing about the scoring there. It's all about the effort, right? Getting that loose ball is what gave Miami that extra possession there to get the ball in the hoop.
14-7 game, RedHawks lead it, their largest lead of the night. Heffling with a top the key for Loyola Chicago. Flips it right side, Nolan off the window for two with a right arm as she got a good look in the post. RedHawk defense kind of collapsed. Miami up the floor, Watkins left side of the paint, goes up and under and puts it in for two with a beautiful move near side to far side, 16-9 Miami. Oh, Chicago stripped near wing of their offensive end. Galanopoulos taken away by a Wolf up ahead, the pass, the layup, it's good by Clues. And the RedHawks will force the Ramblers to take a timeout. 18-8 your score with 2:43 to go in the first, as the RedHawks open up this game to a 10-point advantage late in the opening quarter.
Yeah, Patrick, I don't think it's, you know, what's going on here is not rocket science. When you play with great effort, great things are going to happen on the other end of the ball. When you play great defense, it translates to great offense, and that's what I'm seeing a lot here. A lot of girls are closing out on shooters, fighting for loose balls inside. You know, it's been a couple turnovers here and there, but, you know, when you make up with it with great effort, great things happen for you.
Yep.
So, thus far, if you're Coach Hendricks, you'd have to be really happy for the team. You know, giving you an 18-9 lead thus far,
right.
It's just, once again, maintaining that throughout this full game is going to be the key.
So a quick 30-second timeout called by Loyola Chicago after the RedHawks open up the 18-9 lead by 9 points. Chivers over the timeline here on the right wing for Loyola Chicago. Goes top of the key with it. Here's Anna Brown. Back up top for Satori Tannen. Near wing with it outside the arc, Galanopoulos gets to the right side of the paint, flips a prayer off the glass and in for two. She was going up against Scott and just basically said, hopefully this goes in. She flew it up and went in, 18-11 Miami.
Looks like we're seeing a little bit of a press here from Loyola Chicago, trying to maybe force Miami to get some turnovers here.
RedHawks over the timeline, left wing, Scott with the ball, 16 to shoot. Far wing with it is Matty Kloos. Outside the arc, top of the key, Scott. This is right wing, Kloos, cross court, left wing, Ivy Wolf outside the arc, 7 to shoot. Bounce pass, right side of the post, Kloos flew it up, but she was fouled. Heavy contact there from the Ramblers. And it's Tan and they're going to whistle Brown for the foul. That'll be her first, second as a team against Loyola Chicago. 1:57 left in quarter number one and an 18-11 game, and Matty Kloos from the free throw line will shoot two. Looks like Scott going to take a quick breather here as Tiana Hendricks pulls her out of the game. First free throw too far right, and a miss by Kloos.
Yeah, if Loyola Chicago is going to play that press against you, it's going to demand perfect execution passing the ball. You got to be very precise in how you're throwing it, you know, because once again, if you give up quick turnovers here, this game could get back to being tighter.
Next one, goodbye, Kloos. Jimmers over the line. The timeline, middle of the floor for Loyola Chicago in a 19-11 Red Hawk lead, late opening quarter. With the ball is Tannen. Far side, Loyola Chicago goes top the key. Left wing, Brown drives down the edge of the paint. They work it back up top for Nolan. Trying to feed it right side of the paint. 9 to shoot with a basketball. Tannen dishes back. Right wing three. Brown way too much on it. Rebound fought for. RedHawks can't come up. It was Nolan who got the tip. She drove away by herself. Left side of the post. Off the glass too much. They fight for it. Top of the key on the RedHawks end of the floor. And a foul is whistled on the Ramblers. It was basically Kloos all alone in there for the RedHawks, fighting for the loose ball with three other Ramblers. And a foul is going to go against Loyola Chicago for their third as a team.
When you've had some of the results Miami's had, losing by, you know, 20 or more points in the last three or so games, the effort Sierra Morrow just gave on the floor is something that you want to teach to everybody, and everybody needs to watch. That is the winning type of effort, fighting for that many loose balls. You know, it was almost a 1-on-5 there for that, and she still continued to fight and got the ball for Miami. Big play.
Sophia Nolan got her first personal there in the contact. RedHawks over the timeline, middle of the floor. Far wing with it, Ivy Wolf back up top of the key here for Sydney Watkins. This is near wing for Chambers. Now right wing outside the arc. Wolf got a cross court feed. Goes back cross court. Chambers left wing 13 to shoot. Three ball is off. That's short. Bounced hard off the iron. Rebound picked up pulled by Freeman. Big offensive board for the RedHawks. Working left wing at the baseline. Chambers working. Dishes back for a jumper by Watkins. Missed it too far right. Rebound to Sierra Morrow. Second straight offensive board by Miami. And here's Wolf outside the arc. Top of the key for the RedHawks. Watkins left wing outside the arc. 10 to shoot. Far wing. Three ball. Wolf too far right. And the RedHawks couldn't get anything to go on that possession.
A tough way for that possession end, but what it was great effort again from Sierra. We saw from Sierra Morrow, last possession, now Matty Kloos. They're just giving great effort and giving you those extra opportunities. You just got to cash them in.
Kalinopoulos with it, top of the key for Loyola Chicago. Walks it back, 13 on the shot clock, 18 seconds to go in the first quarter. Kalinopoulos far wing outside the arc, goes top of the key for Nolan. Back inside the paint, here's Tannen, jumper, too much on it. Rebound RedHawks, 7 seconds to go in the first quarter. Here's Wolf over the timeline on the right wing. 3 to go. Wolf driving in on Chivers will throw up a prayer shot from the right elbow after she got in there. It was short, and the opening 10 minutes is over with here from Millett Hall tonight. The RedHawks on top of Loyola Chicago, 19-11 your score after 10 minutes of play. We are back with the second quarter in moments. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. Thank you. 19-11 is the score. Red Hawks over Loyola Chicago tonight in women's basketball as we start the second quarter from Millett Hall. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland back with you courtside from inside the arena. And Patrick, you mentioned the effort was really there for the Red Hawks in the first quarter a lot. The question is, can they continue it into the second quarter? That's what's going to determine their success as we move forward in this game.
Yeah, I think if you're Coach Hendricks, that's what you're telling your team on the sideline. You know, they're playing with great effort. It's just, we talked about, you got to maintain that all throughout four quarters. It's, you know, Loyola Chicago, it seems like their game plan is to go inside, play a lot of girls at tough inside, get go to the rim. Miami's shooting a lot of outside shots right now. I'd like to see them go maybe back to the rim, keep playing physical. You know, they've been doing a great job of getting those offensive rebounds, but I'd like to see maybe some more layups, more passing inside, work them inside, and then maybe take your outside shot.
Red Hawks are 8-for-19 from the field in the game so far. That's 42%. Loyola Chicago is 5-for-14 from the field, 35.7%. Red Hawks 1-for-5 from outside the arc. Ramblers are 1-for-4. The Red Hawks with the 8-point lead coming into the second quarter. Their largest lead in the game was 9 points when it was 18-9 with 2:43 to go in the first. Actually, what is that? 7-point lead. I'm sorry. I'm so bad at math.
No.
Is it 7 or 8?
Nine minus one is eight.
Gosh.
It's an 8-point game.
I'll tell you what. It's why I'm a journalism major.
No. It's a Monday. We're nearing the end of the semester. I understand it.
Got it. So an 8-point Red Hawk lead, 19-11. What do you want to see out of Loyola Chicago here as we start the second quarter? Obviously, they kind of had a little bit of trouble finding their legs there in that first quarter, but maybe a little bit more energy at the end of that opening quarter. Going to continue that?
Yeah, I think, you know, their game plan seems to be, like I said, you know, a lot of inside, a lot of going with Sophia Turner. You know, she seems to be the player they're really focusing on today. I think we're going to continue to see that. It's just for them, I think, just playing more consistent, right? They have had some turnovers here and there, but I think their game plan is going to remain the same. Go inside with Sophia Turner and play aggressive.
Yep. So the inbound comes near side of the center court line as Chivers goes to Tannen. Loyola Chicago opens up with the ball. They move left to right across your radio here in the second quarter of play. Left side at the elbow is Emma Nolan. This is near wing outside the arc. Brown in and out with a three-pointer. Rebound fought for in the hoop, and it's going to go out of bounds to the baseline and return back to the Red Hawks with 9:41 to go in the second. 19 seconds gone by in the second quarter. Here's close over the timeline, middle of the floor for the Red Hawks. This is near wing outside the arc for Chambers. Her feet cross court. Went off the arm of Gallinopoulos, then went out of bounds off of Chambers, right up against the sideline on the near wing, and Loyola Chicago, a lucky break, back with the ball. Tannen inbounds to Chambers over the timeline, middle of the floor for the Ramblers. She lost it though, coughed it up, Watkins picks up, charges over the timeline on the right wing. Freeman with it, the free throw line, will hold on to the ball, hit the brakes. Dish back to the far wing, Watkins, top of the key, and now with the ball, that was Morrow. Now Kloose with it, left wing outside the arc. Going through the MAC logo in the paint from near side to far side, she was fouled. And I believe they will inbound the ball here with 9:08 to go in the second quarter and 20 seconds on the shot clock for the Red Hawks. Ivy Wolf can return into the game. They're gonna take out Chambers and a Red Hawk lead of 19-11 so far early in the second quarter.
I think what makes Maddie Kloos that 19-point a game score is she's so decisive, right? You know, she picks up that pivot foot and she goes right to the rim.
Wolf, far corner three is good. She was just on the line. They're going to say a three-pointer after she got the inbound. And the Red Hawks open up a 22-11 advantage here. Well, Chicago with the ball. Gallinopoulos top the key, near wing with it is Brown around the arc to the left elbow. Dishes back. With it here is Chiverson to chase the pass. Went too far right. 10 on the shot clock, Chivers around the arc in the far wing. Back up top, the key for Tannen. Drives her way down left side of the paint, flipped it off the side of the backboard of the right arm. And here come the Red Hawks. Loose on the timeline of the left wing. Cuts her way to the free throw line. Dishes back with it, here is Wolf. Right-handed dribble, Ivy Wolf around the arc. Flips it up top, the key for Morrow. Down low left side of the paint with it is Freeman. Spins around off the window with the left arm. She was a little bit too left there. And the rebound of the Loyola Chicago as it's Gallinopoulos over the timeline left wing. She'll get her way down left side of the free throw area. Dish back for Chivers. Gallinopoulos shovels far side for Heffling. Back up top, Gallinopoulos with 15 on the shot clock for the Ramblers. Gallinopoulos back for Tannen, top the key. 8 to shoot. Chambers, Prayer, right wing three. Too much on it. The rebound grabbed by the RedHawks. Morrow brings it down, but her feet to Wolf on the near wing. Chambers came in to aggressively try to take it away. She made some strong contact there with Morrow. And a foul is whistled on Loyola Chicago for their second of the quarter. RedHawks lead ball near side of their own end of the floor. RedHawks with a few substitutions, including Peyton Scott coming back in the game.
Yeah, whatever Loyola Chicago is going to score tonight, it's going to have to be earned. They're closing. Miami's closing out really well to the ball, getting to a lot of the shooters fast. Nothing has been very easily earned yet for Loyola Chicago. It's going to have to be extremely hard fought.
Morrow top of the key for Ivy Wolf. Near wing outside the arc is Peyton Scott with the ball. Right-handed dribble around the arc. This is far wing Kloos. Holds on with both arms. Kloos will jump it from the free throw line. It's good. It's one of those that have not really gone in well for the RedHawks tonight. Kloos will sink it from 16 feet away. 24-11 Miami. 7-12 to go in the second quarter. Ramblers with the ball top of the key. Ramage hands it off. Here is Brown to the right side of the paint. Spins around, puts it off the window too much. Maddie Kloos down the ball for the RedHawks over the timeline here in the right wing. Near side with it is Wolf to the corner. Scott, three ball is good for the RedHawks. And Peyton Scott coming back with a bang here tonight. There's 5 points for her.
Yeah, I think if you're Coach Hendricks and the RedHawks right now, you got to keep your foot on the gas pedal right now. You know, you're up by 16 points. Loyola Chicago, looks like I got the ball out of bounds.
Gallinopoulos carried up the left wing, let it go out of bounds. 6:42 to go on the second. It was right for the RedHawk bench and the offensive end of the floor for Loyola Chicago. But the Ramblers going to stay with the ball. So Gallinopoulos will inbound here, far side, right from the RedHawk bench in the offensive end. Far corner hits the bounce feed there to Heffling. Dishes back Gallinopoulos. Heffling up top of the key for Loyola Chicago. Far side Gallinopoulos, 6.5 to go in the second. 8 to shoot for the Ramblers. Gallinopoulos bounce pass to the post area. Heffling was 3 feet left of it and missed her and went out of bounds. And the RedHawks will get the basketball back here with 6:25 to go in the second quarter.
As I was saying, Patrick, you have a 16-point lead right now. You know, this is a time, like I'm saying, keep the foot on the gas pedal. Keep playing great offense. They haven't turned the ball over at all, Miami, right now. This is a great opportunity to really start to get some momentum here and put this team away.
Top of the key, Kloos to the far wing, Watkins. Far side, Morrow holds it above her head. Dishes to the far corner with it. Here's Kloos. Back up top of the key, Wolf. Far side, Morrow. Wolf again, top of the key with 8 to shoot. Dishes near wing outside the arc. Watkins, left side of the paint. Here is Freeman. Far side to go with 2 to shoot. Wolf, 3 ball was short. Well short there from Wolf. And Chandler with it over the timeline. Left wing, Loyola Chicago got the rebound. Hands it off on a screen from Ramage. Top of the key now is Tannen. Down the left side of the paint. Floats up a shot. Good there. From 10 feet away. A little floater without much coverage defensively from the RedHawks. 27-13 Miami.
If you're Loyola Chicago, you just wanted to see something go in the basket there. That felt like that was a significant run for Miami.
For real. Morrow far side for Wolf. Right wing outside the arc is Watkins. Bounce pass top of the key for Morrow. Far side now Watkins to the corner. Freeman dishes through the paint. Grabbed there by Kloos near corner. Wolf, three ball is good with 4 to shoot. RedHawks turning it on from outside the arc the last few minutes. 30-13 Miami. 5 minutes to go in the second quarter.
It seemed like this offense from the top of the key with Ivy Wolf, whether she's playing at the top or in the corner, she's finding a lot of great chances and a lot of great opportunities, and she's cashing them in.
Yep. Gallinopoulos here, near side of the paint. This is back out left wing. Tannen's got it. Flips it inside, left side of the paint. Here's Heffling, spun around, floated it off the glass for 2 with the right arm. 30-15 Miami with a lead as Heffling able to find some points there. 4:30 left, second quarter. Outside the arc of the right wing is Ivy Wolf for the RedHawks. Dribbles here with the left arm. Dishes to the near wing with it is Sydney Watkins. We get a whistle here. It's a violation on the RedHawks. Gonna send the basketball back to Loyola Chicago as we get immediate timeout with 4:23 to go in the second. As the RedHawks, there was some illegal movement inside the arc. 30-15, Miami with the lead over Loyola Chicago, and this is Miami basketball on RedHawk Radio.
Hello, hello. Welcome back to Millett Hall. I've got the halftime show in just a few short moments. We've got ourselves a good one. Miami up big against the Ramblers of Loyola Chicago, 30-15. I'm going to send it back to both Patricks, Patrick Gresham and Patrick Holland. They've got the rest of the half here at Millett Hall.
Thank you, Andrew. Looking forward to it. 4:23 to go in quarter number two. Miami 30, Loyola Chicago 15, and the RedHawks have kept up the effort so far in the second quarter. Good sign to see.
Yeah, it seems like whatever happened in the first quarter has bled into the second. And I'm looking at it now. You know, you talked about the last game. Andrew talked about it. Maddie Kloss and Ivy Wolf combined for 45 points.
Yeah.
They have 29 combined right now. Something, they have found something with those two players, and it's translating into the games right now.
Yeah.
That's a formula that I think is going to be able to work, not just tonight, but maybe going forward for a while.
Ivy Wolf is 13 points tonight to lead the RedHawks. She's 5-for-9 from the field, 3-for-6 from outside the arc. That's been working really well for her. And a RedHawk team that's almost shooting 50% from the field, Patrick. That's a big part of their success. 12-for-25 from the field so far tonight.
Yeah, they're kind of giving Loyola Chicago a taste of their, you know, this is Miami has struggled a little bit in the last three games. They're kind of giving the punches back to Loyola Chicago, letting out some of that aggression, you know, some of that frustration from those couple games. They're playing great so far.
Yeah.
And it's just, like we're talking about, just maintaining consistency all throughout the four quarters.
Rambler team 7-for-20 from the field, 35% for Loyola Chicago, who themselves 1-for-6 as a team outside the arc here tonight. RedHawks 4-for-9 from three-point land this evening. That's 44% so far for Miami. So Loyola Chicago inbounds the ball to our left at the end of the floor, as it is Tannen who takes over the timeline, middle of the floor, and will dish to the near wing for Gallinopoulos. So the Ramblers down by 15 with 4:10 to go in the second quarter. Far wing of the ball is Chandler with it, top of the key for Heffling. To the near wing, a feed there for Ramage to the corner. You got Gallinopoulos trying to get the pass, get tipped out of bounds though off a red hot hand. Good defensive work by Scott, who's looking pretty darn good so far tonight, just her third game of the year.
Looks like she hasn't missed a beat at all. She's come out fresh. I mean, the whole roster looks like they're really flying around with the ball. It seems like that was a message from Coach Hendricks. Play aggressive, fly to the basketball, and they're really doing it well.
Near wing outside the arc, Tannen. Three to shoot, Loyola Chicago. Right side of the paint, up and under. Heffling flipped it with a right arm. No good. It was short. Rebound RedHawks over the timeline, right wing. Here's Wolf. This is back for Scott. Outside the arc, right side. We'll walk this one back toward the big red M at half court. Far side, Wolf to the corner. With the ball over her head, there is Katie Richardson in the game for the RedHawks. Kloos, far wing, is going to be called for a travel. She was inside the arc trying to go toward the paint, took a step too many on a drive toward the hoop. 3.5 to go in the second. RedHawks still lead by 15 at 30-15. Chandler topped the key for Heffling for Loyola Chicago. Ramage through the Mac logo with the paint, flips it off the window too much with the left arm, but she was fouled. So two shots at the line here coming for Mallory Ramage, the freshman from Mattoon, Illinois. Richardson picks up her first foul of the night.
And this is a way, you know, this is the first free throws for Loyola Chicago. This is a way a team can get back into the game. It's kind of methodical. You give them a couple free throws here and there. This lead is at 15. Let's keep it, I like to keep it at 15, 12, something like that. If it gets under 10 like that, it gets a little concerning going at half. But this is how a team kind of inches their way back into shooting free throws.
Yeah. First free throw is good. In from Mallory Ramage. She's a freshman again from Illinois. Points in three of her last six appearances. At 7 minutes in the St. Francis game that Loyola Chicago played on Friday at home. Next one was good, so it's a 30-17 RedHawk lead. Scott with the ball over the timeline, left wing for the RedHawks. This is back for Ivy Wolf. Far side with it is Sydney Watkins. Outside the arc, close with the ball for the RedHawks. Top of the key for Payne Scott. 13 to shoot Scott. This is right wing outside the arc as Wolf walks her way to the right side of the paint. Back outside Watkins, left side of the elbow. Top of the key with it, Scott. Three ball is off, too far right. Rebound picked up by Tannen, who flips left wing and over the timeline is Gallinopoulos for Loyola Chicago. Top of the key with it, Tannen. Down the left side of the paint, floats it down low. And a whistle for a charge on Tannen as she knocked to the floor, Ivy Wolf. Trying to feed it down low to the post. The ball going back to the RedHawks with 2:42 to go in the second. 30-17 game, Miami on top. Of course, the RedHawks losing at Evansville on Saturday. And that was a tough one. 97-72 was the final. Miami team that comes in having lost three in a row. And the Ramblers have lost four of their last five themselves. Going outside the arc is Scott. Top of the key with it. Here is Wolf for the RedHawks offensive end. Far side, Kloose, free throw line. We'll hit the brakes, dish it back outside, top to Key Wolf. Another triple try, it's good. Ivy Wolf is 4-for-7 from three-point land tonight, 33-17 Miami. Ramblers with the ball outside the arc in the near wing. It's Chandler. Dish is back for Gallinopoulos. 18 to shoot, she'll float one off the window too much. But a foul whistle on the RedHawks. Think Wolf got in there for a little bit too much contact, and that is the call with 2:05 remaining in quarter number two.
Ivy Wolf looks incredible so far.
Yeah.
I mean, 17 points in the first half. She's made 4-for-7 from the three-point line. She seems to have, what happened in the Evansville game is really starting to translate into this game, and it looks like it's a winning formula.
Gallinopoulos from the free throw line will miss the first one too far left. 2:05 to go in the second quarter. Gallinopoulos from Skokie, Illinois, nearby Chicago. Started every game, including tonight, for the Ramblers this season. The next one sinks through, and it's 33-18, the RedHawks lead. Scott's going to come out for Deanna Hendricks, still limiting her minutes a little bit. Of course, Peyton wearing that brace on her right knee. Still not 100% yet, but looking to probably get a little bit more time than she did against Evansville on Saturday. RedHawks the ball offensive end, a feed to the baseline area from top of the key. Clues get tipped out of bounds off a Rambler hand. As Freeman was trying to get the ball in the air for the RedHawks, so Wolf will trot down and inbound it near side of the baseline for the RedHawks with 15 to shoot. Try to flip it in at the post area. Freeman missed the feed. Here comes Ramage for Loyola Chicago. Hits the brakes outside the arc. Dishes it toward the paint. Nolan there was scooped it up, but is fouled. And number 11 from the RedHawks, Cindy Watkins, will pick up her first of the night. 13 foul against Miami. Loyola Chicago is three as well with 1:41 to go in the second. And an inbound comes far side of the offensive baseline for the Ramblers.
Since that last time out, Patrick, it looks like Loyola Chicago has really re-engaged on the defense side of the ball. A lot more communication from them. They're playing a lot harder than they did in the last previous minutes.
Ewing with it inside the arc, Kefling. Far side is Chandler. Will jump it from the left elbow. That was too hard. Rebound grabbed by the RedHawks. Think a foul whistle here on the Ramblers. As Watkins brought it down in the paint. Don't know who they call exactly for the Ramblers. 1:27 to go in the second. 33-18 the lead for Miami. It's a 14th foul against Loyola Chicago. Check on the foul here. Canucks with the top of the key with 1:17 to go in the half. Far wing is Chambers with it for the RedHawks. Top the key, Kloose. Near wing outside the arc is Wolf with a right-handed dribble. Ivy Wolf spin around MacLog with the paint. Floats it up too hard off the window. Gallinopoulos the rebound for the Ramblers. Up ahead left wing, the stretch feed forward. Ramage with it. Near wing they go with three balls. Chandler outside the arc, too much on it. As it went off the back of the iron and a jump ball on the rebound is Ramage tied up with Chambers. Possession arrow right now with Miami with 54.7 to go. And the Rex will inbound from the far side of their own end of the floor here in the second quarter, up 33-18. Can you hear Deanna Hendricks there barking orders to her team on the offensive end of the floor? Far side with it, Watkins. Whistle for a foul. I think Heffling that time got in some contact. Your partner is actually Sophia Nolan for Loyola Chicago. Fifth is a team for the Ramblers, so the RedHawks have the bonus right now. At the line will be Sierra Morrow. He's going to shoot two here. First one is good.
I think Miami's done a great job so far weathering that storm. Like I said, it looked like out of that timeout, Loyola Chicago looked re-energized. They're playing a lot harder on defense. Miami keeps moving the ball around, keep playing tough, and I think they'll be able to weather this storm.
Still not over yet by any means.
No, long ways to go.
35-17 game, or 35-18 game rather, with 43 seconds to go in the second quarter. Gallinopoulos on the timeline, middle of the floor for Loyola Chicago. Hands it back for an attempt by Ramage through the paint. Floated it off the iron too much. Rebound goes out of bounds. They're going to say it stays with the Ramblers. A contested call, I guess. Some of the fans didn't like it. Inbound will come from the Ramblers near side of their own baseline, their offensive baseline, rather. It'll come off the hands of Anna Brown as Chandler will come back in for the Ramblers. 20 on the shot clock, 34.8 is left in the second quarter. Chandler in the near wing for Gallinopoulos. Outside the arc, walks her way around the arc, back to the Emmett, the half court line. Top of the key is Gallinopoulos. 9 to shoot for Loyola Chicago, 20 seconds to go in the second. Gallinopoulos, right side of the elbow, hands it back, Chandler. Three ball is up, too much on it. Rebound for the RedHawks with 13 to go, but then it was stolen away. Put back up by Brown, she missed it. And the RedHawks back with it again. 5 seconds to go. Clouseau on the timeline here on the left wing. Drives her way to the paint area, floated it over the hoop. And that'll bring us to halftime here as the time runs out in the second quarter. Your halftime score, Miami 35, Loyola Chicago 18. What a great first half there by the RedHawks. Patrick Bain Scott was going. That's good news number one. The RedHawks shooting really well from the field, 44%. That's good news number two. And the RedHawks effort and consistency in their play was so good there throughout the entire 20 minutes of basketball action.
Yeah, Patrick, I think if you ask Deanna Hendricks before the game if that's the type of effort and that's the score you get, I think she'd take it 10 times out of 10.
No.
You know, it was, you know, you're getting great efforts out of Ivy Scott, Sierra Morrow, Maddie Close, but the biggest thing is it's just effort all around. Loose balls, like we talked about, talking on the defensive end, closing out on shooters. That's why Loyola Chicago is shooting 1 for 8 from three-point range.
Yep.
You know, it's things like that. It's the little things when you're struggling are going to get you out of it. It's working for it and giving great effort.
Exactly.
And that's what I'm seeing so far in this first half.
All right, time for the halftime report. We send it over to Andrew. Go ahead.
There's the first shot. Thank you, Patrick. Yes, here come the RedHawks. They are red hot. RedHawks playing extremely well, up by 17, biggest lead of the day. The Miami RedHawks definitely came ready to play here at Millett Hall, doing everything well on all facets of the ball, shooting 45% from the field, 45% from three, and 67% from the charity stripe. So no question about it, they're doing all things right. And I got to imagine that Coach Deanna Hendricks, super proud of this group, you know, after their first win against Vermont, really, really, really digging for that second win. And so far, so good. Looking like they're going to get win number two here if things continue the way that they've been going. Score update for the RedHawks. Ivy Wolf, one of the biggest games of her RedHawk early on career so far. 16 points, 2 rebounds. 2 steals, and really, really, really played well, extremely well. She played 18 minutes, so pretty much played the entire half, doing everything in her bag to give the RedHawks this W, no question about it. Peyton Scott also, a little bit rusty, 2 for 6 from the field, but 5 points, 2 rebounds, 4 assists, and 1 steal. So when she's on the field, great things happen, and the RedHawks, no question about it, they are doing everything in their power to send Loyola home sad with a loss. But I also want to really praise the RedHawks defense, limiting the Ramblers to a mere 27% shooting the ball, 7 for 26. That's kind of depressing. The Ramblers are also 1 for 8 from three-point length. That's 13%. But really great free throw shooting team for Loyola. They're really well coached, and that's what they do. They only make free throws. Really good job there on that facet of the game. But leading scores for Loyola, Galampalos, 5 points on the day, 3 rebounds, 1 assist, and 2 steals. In 20 minutes, she's played the entire half. So expect some more action from her, trying to get the Ramblers back in this one. And Nolan as well, Sophia Nolan, 5 points. 1 for 1 on three-pointers. She has 1 rebound. So overall, both Galampalos and Nolan trying to do everything in their power to give the Ramblers a strong second half and hit it where it counts most against the Miami RedHawks, who are down by a big one, by 17 points. So we shall see what happens in the second half. Don't go anywhere. It's Miami basketball here on RedHawk Radio. Welcome back to Millett Hall, currently at halftime right now. I am Andrew Revis once again, giving you a scoreboard update from all across the nation in women college hoops. The UNC Asheville currently on top of Western Carolina by 9. That game is slowly winding down. 40 seconds left in the third, so UNC Asheville looking for their third win. So far, so good for them. That game is in its closing stages. Wofford, the Terriers, they are up by 11 against Southern Wesleyan, 31-20, so up by 11 at home, searching for their fourth win. So far, so good for them. They are doing everything they can to get some more wins at home. Furman is currently up by 19 against Pfeiffer. That game is at the half, 47-28, so up by 19. Really doing a good job there. So far, so good for them, playing well at home. Bowling Green blowing out Detroit Mercy, 43-11, so a 32-point blowout at half. Expect some subs to play in then. Should no question about it. Very tough team in Bowling Green, so looking like they're getting another win there tonight. The Akron Zips are currently up by 3 over the Northern Kentucky Norse by 3 at half. So very close game, should be fun down the stretch. Wright State is currently down by 26 against Eastern Illinois. Eastern Illinois 5-0 on the year, looking for win number 6, looking to stay perfect. They're at home. They're up big at half. Central Connecticut is currently down by 14 against Brown at the half. Brown 4-2 on the year, looking for win number 5. That would be a sweet road victory, up by 14 at the half. We've already got Miami Loyola here. Miami's up big by 17. Let's see if they can extend the lead and get this much-needed W for the RedHawks. The Ole Miss Rebels blowing out Texas Southern at their own house. Ole Miss up by 23, so they are doing extremely well. Looking to improve to 6-1 and 4-0 at home. Could very well happen. Central Christian College and Oral Roberts yet to tip off here. That game is going to start at 8 Eastern time in Oklahoma. That game should be a good one. Maine against number 23 Gonzaga, the Gonzaga Bulldogs, looking to defend their home turf once again and improve to 3-0 on the year at home and 6-1 on the year against Maine. That game tips off at 9 Eastern. The Pepperdine Waves are taking on the Cal State Fullerton Titans. That game will tip off at 10 o'clock on East Coast time. And that is a home game for Cal State Fullerton. So two fun beach teams. Who doesn't love beach basketball? I don't know who doesn't, but that should be a very fun game for sure. The South Dakota State Jackrabbits taking on the Washington State Cougars. That game will tip off at 10 o'clock p.m. That game is going to be played at Pullman. And already our first win of the day, Norfolk State. They won big against Campbell, the Campbell Camels. They improved to 7-1 on the year, 2-0 at home. So Norfolk State getting it done, no question about it. Wheeler had a double-double on the day, 15 points, 10 rebounds. That's dominant without a question. So that was the score update. Now we're going to take a quick minute break, and we will be right back here at Millett breaking down what's going to happen in the second half. Don't go anywhere. It's Miami basketball here on Red Hawk Radio. Thanks. Welcome back to Millett Hall. We are just a few minutes away from tipping off with this second half getting about underway here. Gonna send it over to the broadcasters, Patrick Holland and Patrick Geshan, in just a few moments. But overall, Miami enjoying a 17-point lead. They're up by double digits, playing extremely well. Like I said at the beginning of the game, look out for Ivy Wolf, and Ivy Wolf has not disappointed. 4 3-pointers on the day. RedHawks shooting a scorching hot 45% from three-point land. So when you're shooting like that, you know you're in a great spot, no question about it. And they're also playing extremely well. Tight defense, choking defense. They're doing everything right in their book. That's why they're up big, almost doubling up on the Ramblers scoreboard. So it'll be absolutely interesting to see how the RedHawks end up in the second half. We'll see if some bench players like Jesse Dye or Katie Richardson get in the game more and try and put this game away. So far so good for the RedHawks. Half number one is a check mark. They did everything right. All facets of stat lines, just everything. Perfect half. You couldn't draw it up more better, no question about it. So Miami up by 17. Let's see if Ivy Wolf and co. continue their dominance over the Loyola Ramblers. Let's see if Miami can send Loyola home empty and get a nice little win, nice little home win here. Feels like it's been way too long since Miami's won at home. and one in general, but so far so good for the RedHawks, looking to end a three-game losing streak. It's definitely looking like that today. We shall see. Just a few moments, I'm going to send it over to Patrick Holland and Patrick Geshan, who have the second half for you, and I will have the post-game show for you. Let's see if the RedHawks can tighten down on the Ramblers once again. Let's see if they can limit the Loyola points. Let's see if they can have an even better second half. Let's see if the RedHawks can make it less than 18 points. How sweet would that be? The RedHawks defense just clamping down. Let's see if they can have another defensive clinic like they've done the first half. But so far, so good for the RedHawks. Half number one is in the books. Miami 35, Loyola 18. I'm going to be sending over to Patrick Holland and Patrick Geshan. Got ourselves a fun one here. It's Miami 35, Loyola 18. I'm going to be sending it over to our two sensational broadcasters, Patrick Holland and Patrick Geshan. They've got you the rest of the way in this half, and I've got the post-game show at the end of this one. And sending it over to Patrick and Patrick.
Thank you, Andrew. Great job on the halftime report. It is a 35-18 lead for the Miami RedHawks over the Ramblers from Loyola Chicago. Patrick Holland, what do you want to see out of the RedHawks in the second half for them to close out this win?
Well, Patrick, I think it goes back to what we talked about before the game started, right? You wanted to see them come out fast, come out with a lot of energy, a lot of passion, and I think they did that in the first half. Right now, it's coming in the second half. Everybody went to halftime. It's bringing that energy into the second half, right? Carrying that energy, that momentum, that passion all the way through the next 20 minutes, it's going to be key. And, you know, the shooting they've done outside has been incredible so far. You know, that might cool off here and there, so you can't get discouraged when you miss those threes, but I'd say keep shooting them.
I would agree. RedHawks team, those 45% almost from the field in that first half of play. Loyola Chicago opens up with the ball, and they move right to left across your radio here in this third quarter. Ramblers with it top of the key. It's Tannen to the near wing for Galanopoulos outside the arc. She'll drive away across the paint, get tipped up in the air by Ivy Wolf. She'll come down with it. And with the basketball is Wolf on a great turnover generated there on the timeline left wing to Kloos. Flips it in left side of the paint for Freeman. Off the window, too much on it. But a foul is whistled as Freeman trying to go two in the glass for two. And the foul will go against Sophia Nolan, her third of the night for Loyola Chicago.
Freeman hasn't got a bucket yet, but she's been great inside so far, getting those turnaround shots early. She's missed a couple of them, but there she goes to the free throw line.
Yep. First one is too much from Monty Freeman, 72% shooter at the line, senior forward from Avon, Indiana. Started in every game so far for the RedHawks this year. The next one short. 35-18 RedHawk lead after that possession. 9:24 to go. Quick feed inside of the post area. Tannen trying to flip it up with the left arm off the window for two. She missed it too far left. Back with a rebound of the RedHawks on the timeline right wing. Wolf trying to shovel one down low for Freeman on a feed. It went past her outstretched right arm and out of the baseline. And the ball going back to Loyola Chicago here with 9:14 to go in the third. They'll inbound it from their own end of the floor. Top of the key, Ramblers win it. Tannen's got the ball. Right elbow, dishes back outside the arc for Chandler. Drives her way right side of the paint off the glass for two with two arms. Good job there by Chandler. And the score now 35-20 Miami as Wolf carries over the timeline here, middle of the floor for the RedHawks. Bounce pass left wing there for Kloos. Gets it left side of the paint for Freeman. She'll work down low with a right-handed dribble. Dish back up top the key for Kloos. Right-handed dribble, hands it off for Chambers. RedHawks have eight to shoot. Left wing three, Wolf, too much. Rebound on the offensive end for Freeman. Right wing they go, Kloos, top of the key. Chambers with a long-range three, and she sinks it. She was a good 3 feet behind the three-point line there and got it to go in. 18-point RedHawk lead. Ramblers with it here under the basket. It is Chandler, flips to the near wing outside the arc. Brown. Give and go there was Tannen. We get a whistle here for a travel. on Loyola Chicago as too many steps there for Tannen coming through. We get a timeout called here by Miami with 8:13 to go in the third. It's also a media timeout with the RedHawks leading by a score of 38-20. We'll be back to Millett Hall in just moments. Miami basketball on RedHawk Radio.
Totally.
.13 to go in the third quarter, 38-20 Miami over Loyola Chicago here from inside Millett Hall. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland back with you as the RedHawks moving left to right. We'll inbound with the basketball here of our timeout. RedHawks calling it there. Deanna Hendricks whistling the timeout just to kind of get her group back in regroup mode. Maddie Kloos will inbound here from the baseline to our left.
It seems like the last couple of possessions, Patrick, there's been an intense focus on the Loyola Ramblers to make sure where Ivy Wolf is at all times.
Right.
You saw Sam Ganopoulos on her last time. Looks like Shivers is going to press her to come out of this possession, but they are not going to let her beat them like she did in the first half. There seems to be a much more intent focus on keep making sure where she is at all times.
I agree. So you're going to have the RedHawks on offense here. Miami shooting 45.2%. From the field so far in the game. Loyola Chicago just 28.6% shooting in the game so far. Wolf with it over the timeline here on the right wing for the RedHawks. Dishes near wing outside the arc. Here is Maddie Kloos with the ball. 2 minutes gone by here in this third quarter. Chambers hands off top of the key. With it is Ivy Wolf. Back for Chambers on the far side. Trying to get a screen there from Wolf. 7 on the shot clock. Wolf. Left side will try to spin around. Mack Logan the paint, a drive in off the glass for two. Ivy Wolf, beautiful job. She was double teamed inside and got 2 points out of it. Chandler's on the timeline, right wing for Loyola Chicago. Now it's Gallinopoulos. Around the arc on the far side. Bounce past Chandler, left wing at the elbow. Back outside the arc, she'll take it. Chandler holds it above her head. Top of the key, back for Gallinopoulos. Shot clock reads 8. She'll drive right side on Freeman. Never got a shot up. 5 to shoot. Chandler, left side of the paint, will float it up, and it is good. Spun around on the rim for the and one as Chandler floated it up with a foul. And she'll have a chance at a 3-point play at the line. 40-22 Miami, 7:15 to go in the third.
I think it was great defense by Claire Chambers. Actually, great defense by the whole RedHawks on that possession. You know, that's just a better play by Chambers there on that bucket. You just got to give her credit.
Yep. Free throw will come here from Chandler, who's a per- perfect free throw shooter on the year, 20 for 20, and she'll make it 21 for 21. Well, that's sick. She is the freshman of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference, couple seasons ago. This is the first year Loyola Chicago, by the way, is in the 8-10. They were in the Missouri Valley Conference before this, first year in the new league. Top of the key with it is Wolf to the near corner for Kloos. RedHawks on offense, goes far corner now. Watkins drives her way through the MAC logo here in the paint. Floats it back for Wolf, left wing with five to shoot. Long range three is good. Nothing but net for Ivy Wolf, who was 5 for 9 from 3-point land tonight. Top of the key, Tannen for Loyola Chicago. Down the right side of the paint, off the window too much. And a whistle here for the foul. She shot it up. Maddie Kloos will get the foul, her first of the night. And a 20-point RedHawk lead at 43-23 with 6:38 to go in the third. RedHawks have not had this big of a lead all year, Patrick. It's going to be almost a challenge to kind of manage this mentality.
Right, well, I think if you're Coach Hendricks, you just keep saying, just keep doing what you've been doing so far. You know, you don't have to change anything when you get build a lead like this. Just keep it with the same intensity. You don't have to wonder if Loyola Chicago is going to send a double team to Ivy Wolf. I mean, the amount of time she's killing him inside, she's got him outside, now she's making shots inside. You have to wonder if they're just going to send a double team and say, please let somebody else beat us outside of her.
Tannen makes the second one. She missed the first one in the two trips at the line. 43-24, the Red Hawk lead, 6:35 to go fourth quarter. Scott's over the timeline, left wing for the Red Hawks with a left-handed dribble. Walks her way around the arc in the far wing. Goes up top to key for Sydney Watkins. Down the arc to the right side. Now back up top for Ivy Wolf. 13 to shoot. Down low Freeman in the paint. Tried to get the feed and went below her. And was scooped up by the Ramblers. On the timeline, left wing is Maya Chandler. Chandler around the arc in the far wing. The right-handed dribble. Floats a feed down low and feet. It's picked up there by Kloos. Will grab it for the Red Hawks and take it over the timeline, left wing. First side with it here is Ivy Wolf for the Red Hawks. Will float it from the far wing, and it's in for two. The red carpet rolled out there for Ivy Wolf, who got to the rim and put it in for 2 points. And Shivers the other way for Loyola Chicago, gets fouled, left elbow. Driving from coast to coast. Ivy Wolf gets her second on the play, 5:50 left in the third quarter. In a 45-24 Red Hawk lead.
She's just too good right now. I mean, there's just simply, I mean, like we said, I mean, there's just inside, outside. Like I said, I'm surprised I haven't seen a double team yet. Also, I've been really impressed with Miami's transition defense. They have been times where they've had turnovers, but they get back on defense so fast, so quickly. The communication's been great. Haven't seen any really breakdowns on that element of basketball. That's a big, big part of the reason why they have such a lead still.
Kalinopoulos will inbound the ball from the baseline. Kick this one out up top of the key. With it here is Whitney Dunn. Now in the game for the Ramblers. Kicks it back out near wing. Galinopoulos with it. Far elbow. She had the ball. Whacked it back outside the arc. 13 to shoot to the near corner with a basketball now. New player for Loyola Chicago. That's Dunn. Far side with 7 to shoot. Dribbles. Gets it left wing. Galinopoulos through the MAC logo. Trying to get a pass to the post. Went over the head of Julia Hempfling. And out of bounds, Red Hawks will get it back with 5:27 left in the third. 45-24, the Red Hawk lead. Miami back on offense.
Great job by both your forwards there, in Morrow and Freeman. I'm playing defense on a guard in Ganopoulos. They didn't get out of position. They didn't jump when she pumped fake. Remain on their feet, and they play great defense.
Scott the ball inside the MAC logo in the paint. Floats it off the iron a little bit too much. And it hung there for a second, never went in. Shivers with it over the timeline of the right wing. Loyola Chicago back left wing three. Galinopoulos way left on the shot, the miss there. Scott picks up the long rebound, tripped up though at the Miami M at half court, and a foul whistled here. As Dunn came in and body checked her in the big red M at half court, foul whistled to Dunn. Scott does not appear to be too shaken up, gets right up. And I think we got immediate timeout here with 4:58 to go in the third. Miami 45, Loyola Chicago 24 from inside Millett Hall, and this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 4:58 to go, quarter number three, 45-24, Miami on top of Loyola Chicago as we're back inside Millett Hall. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland are with you. So far, the energy has stayed up for the RedHawks in this third quarter.
Yeah, I think it has, and it's, you know, it's like what we talked about. You had to come out with a lot of intensity still. You know, this game is not over yet. But what you're seeing right now from Loyola Chicago, a lot of frustration. A lot of, you know, the coach Allison Guth on the sideline is getting really upset. It didn't seem like they're running their plays there. They had a foul just before half, you know, right before the timeout. Yep. You know, it just seems like they're kind of a little bit unraveling here. If I'm Miami and I'm Coach Hendricks, I'm not telling my team directly that, but I'm starting a message to say, here, you know, we're up by 21. We built a pretty good lead. Just keep playing what we have, and we can stick with the knockout punch into this team.
Yep. It's true. Media timeout wraps up from inside Millett Hall. RedHawks will inbound here in their offensive end of the floor near sideline. It'll be Matty Clouse to send it in for the RedHawks. And Clouse on the floor with Ivy Wolf. Watkins out there. Marl and Peyton Scott is in the game as well. Stays out for a little bit. RedHawks the ball top, the key on the inbound. Ivy Wolf with it. 20 seconds on the shot clock, and he got messed up there by a defender coming in. That was Chivers. RedHawks feed to the left wing, turned over, done. Picked it off for Loyola Chicago, and then she was fouled coming over the timeline on the right wing. As you had Maddie Clouse kind of give her a shoulder to the right side of her body with 4:41 to go in the third quarter. The inbound will come from the Ramblers far side of their offensive end. That's team foul number four on Miami in this third quarter.
I think if you're Loyola, you're going to have to make this game kind of dirty, right? You know, you're not shooting well. You're shooting 30% from the field. You know, you're going to have to kind of make this a more of a rough game and just kind of chip away at the RedHawks if you want any chance to win.
Top the key with it is done for Loyola Chicago. Ramage with a basketball, right side of the elbow, stripped away by Wolf, plays it forward. Here is Peyton Scott with the ball, right side of the paint, off the glass, and it for two with the and one. The foul is whistled against Heffling, I believe, as Scott got to the rack, had a wide open lane, two and up the right side, and floated it off the window for two for the and one. 47-24 Miami, 4:22 to go in the third, and Scott with a three-point play chance. Five for six for the line this year is Scott. As the building gets quiet, she'll sink this one right through.
Yeah, Scott still has that big knee brace on there, but that move looked like she had no issue with that problem. I mean, that was really smooth. Looked like the injury's totally behind her.
It's a
really
good point.
Great play.
Yep, good point. 48-24 off the window. Too much there for him. Done. Right side of the paint for the Ramblers. Rebound Miami. It was Morrow who scooped it up. Hands it off for Wolf. Left wing feet up ahead of the offensive end. Outside the arc in the far wing, there's Riley Neal in the game. Now right wing, Scott, the three, long range is good. Peyton Scott, now is 11 points in the game tonight. Double fingers for the first time this year. Far side Ramblers try three of their own, and that's good. Anna Brown sinks it. Almost a 50% free throw, or three-point shooter, rather, I should say, on the season. 3:35 to go in the third, 51-27, RedHawks.
Yeah, it's great to see Peyton Scott get back in the scoring column, get back feeling like she's healthy and everything. You know, you're out for a little bit of time with an injury like that. You know, extended period of time, she still has that big knee brace on. But, you know, to get in some rhythm, she's having a lot of emotion as she scores. It's really nice to see that.
Riley Neal missed a jumper from the left side of the paint. A little bit too much on it. Loyola Chicago over the timeline here on the left wing. Here's Anna Brown. Jumper there from the far side of the paint. That one missed. A little bit too much on it. RedHawks the rebound up ahead. Far side pass to Clouse. And then as she hit on the near wing of the post, Morrow off the window for two with the right arm. In transition, Loyola Chicago a feet up ahead. Gallinopoulos on the near side of the post finished after a far away feed from Chivers. 53-29, Miami leads with 2:48 to go in the third. Loose over the timeline, middle of the floor for the RedHawks. Gets it inside for Scott. Free throw line jumper, good. Kind of fell backward there, and a quick feed in from Clouse. Scott, 13 in the game, and a timeout called by the Ramblers. 2:37 to go in the third. 23 points for Ivy Wolf, 13 for Peyton Scott, leading the charge for the RedHawks. You mentioned Scott, the way she's playing tonight looks so good out there, so natural like her usual self. Didn't really look that way the first couple times she came in this season with the injury, but that's such a good sign to see for Miami fans. Your star player is starting to get back to normal.
Absolutely. And I think when you come back from a serious injury like that, it's not the game. You know, she knows how to play. She's the top 10 scorer all the time here. It's just feeling comfortable, right?
Yeah.
You know, feeling comfortable cutting. So she still has that big brace on, and she looks smooth right now. She's cutting really smooth, cutting into the rim, you know, making a lot of great shots outside. You know, there's a pull-up, stop really quick. If you can get the type of scoring from Scott and Close and Ivy Wolf, this is going to be a really tough team to beat, and you're going to find some momentum in offense. I really are.
Gallinopoulos will send it in for Loyola Chicago. To the left wing outside the arc is Nolan. Back for Gallinopoulos. Big red M at half court. Top of the key, Nolan to the near wing where the ball is Brown. Right side of the elbow. Try to float a feed to Chivers down low and off her feet and deflected off Wolf out of bounds. At the baseline, so it will go back to Loyola Chicago here on the inbound with Gallinopoulos ready to send it in from the far side of the baseline as Scott will exit the game for the RedHawks. Big smile from her as she exits to the bench. Chicago back with the ball here, left side of the elbow. With it is Nolan, feeds far side for Sophia Nolan. That one was missed. It was Emma Nolan, the feed to Sophia Nolan, their sisters from Valparaiso. Sister combination there didn't quite work out. Here's Wolf, top of the key for the RedHawks, who got the rebound. 2:03 to go, third quarter. Wolf right-handed dribble. Mac Logo floats it up. Too much on that. Left side as well of the iron it went off of. And then he had Chicago's number 14, Sophia Nolan, trying to come out of her own end. She was contacted there by Wolf. A foul is whistled. And falling over with Sophia Nolan. They're going to put the basketball down here with 1:55 to go in the third, and the offensive end for Loyola Chicago. The bonus going to give Sophia Nolan some free throws here. Third personal against Ivy Wolf tonight.
That's been the only negative right now. She's picked up a couple fouls here late in this game. Outside of that, Ivy Wolf's played about good as you can.
So again, all this comes 1:55 to go, third quarter. 55-29 to score. First free throw is good from Sophia Nolan, senior from Valparaiso, Indiana.
On the surface, I think when you talk about this game, you're going to go to the performances of Peyton Scott, Ivy Wolf.
Next one is good.
But the big thing for me has been the play of Sienna Morrow and Amani Freeman inside.
Yep. Yep.
Really underrated performances defensively. They've been a great job inside of not letting their scorers get to the rim.
Right. Wolf took it over the timeline, left wing for the RedHawks, top the key with it. Here's Neal to the far side for Wolf. Right-handed dribble, Ivy Wolf to the right elbow, get poked away there by Nolan. Sophia Nolan, wide open, a jumper, far side is good from Watkins. The ball weirdly deflected to her, she was wide open, no defenders. Sunk it in for two from 12 feet away, 57-31 Miami. Well, Chicago the ball left away in the paint, Sophia Nolan floats it up and in for two from the near side. And the RedHawks march up the floor here on the timeline. Middle of the floor is Maddie Kloos. 1:10 to go in the third quarter.
Seems everybody's getting in on the offense tonight, Patrick. A lot of great offensive performances.
Top of the key, Neal to the near wing. Here is Ivy Wolf. Holds it above her head to the left elbow. The jumper is short. And we get the whistle here as it went out of bounds. So it's going to go back to Loyola Chicago. Almost an air ball and hit the bottom of the netting on the hoop. So you're going to have the inbound come from Tannen, who sends it forward to Chivers for Loyola Chicago over the timeline here on the right wing. Tannen to the near wing for Anna Brown, right elbow. This is far side Chandler outside the arc with it. 45 to go here in the third. 15 on the shot clock. Loyola Chicago outside the arc. Sophia Nolan trying to pass down low for Tannen. Tipped away off her hand. Right side with it, Sophia Nolan. Down inside to Mac Logo in the paint is Tannen. Top to key three, Chandler. Not enough on that. As we get a whistle here for a foul that was called on the rebound. And it popped off the backside of the iron. Fourth team foul in Loyola Chicago. I'm not sure exactly who got it. Big cluster of players around in the area for the Ramblers.
You'd have to think Sophia Nolan. I mean, it looked like she collided with Riley Neal.
Nolan got the foul. Sophia Nolan, her fourth. So she's taken out. Shot clock is off, 25 seconds left. over the timeline, middle of the floor here is Matty Kloos. Right side of the paint, off the rim, too much. But a foul is whistled as she got the shot off. Tannen's going to get the foul for her second for Little Chicago. Came in with contact there on the right arm. 20.1 to go third quarter, 57-33 Miami. As you're going to have Kloos here at the line for two free throws. First one is good. Maddie Kloos tonight, 6 points. Next one sinks through. So now she's up to 7 points. RedHawks 59-33, leaders over the Ramblers. 15 seconds to go, third quarter. Little Chicago with the timeline, middle of the floor. It's Chivers with it, hits the brakes, left elbow, dishes for a right wing drive, and a foul called as the shot too hard on the layup attempt there by the Rambler player that came in. That was Chandler.
Is number zero, Claire Chambers.
Foul called on Chambers of the RedHawks for her second with a contact up high. It was 7.4 to go in the third quarter. Two free throws coming here for Maya Chandler.
Great job by Chandler on that backdoor play right there. There's still, you know, the game's getting a little bit out of reach here and score, but they're still fighting really hard. This is still not over.
First one was good there. We'll get another free throw here from Chandler. And that'll go through as well. 59-35, the lead for Miami. With 5 seconds to go in the third. Over the timeline with the floor is Kloos. Right side with two to go. Her shot was tipped away and out of bounds by Emma Nolan with 0.1 seconds left. Really good play by Nolan to leap up and take that 3-point attempt away. RedHawks getting inbound here. Going to be pretty much a formality with the clock reading 0.1 seconds. Inbound will come there from Maddie Kloos into Ivy Wolf. The clock hits zeros. And our third quarter done with here from Millett Hall tonight. The score, Miami 59, Loyola Chicago 35. Really good job there by the RedHawks, Patrick, in that third quarter. Just keep pushing, keep the momentum going, and they got a pretty healthy lead into the fourth.
Once again, if you're Coach Hendricks, so far your team has listened. The message has got to be play with that same intensity all four quarters. And, you know, you've entered the fourth quarter here. If you start to slip up a little bit here, whatever you've done in the previous three is not going to matter. So I think, but thus far, they've played tremendous. They've played with a lot of effort, a lot of intensity. And this is the type of performance, especially on offense. You know, you get Peyton Scott involved. Ivy Wolf's looked tremendous again. This can really be a formula that translates throughout the rest of the season, something they can look at and say, you know what, we went back to Millett, knocked off the bad feeling from those previous three games and say, I can take this as a building block type game.
Right. Media timeout as well as we start the fourth quarter in just a moment. 59-35 Miami over Loyola Chicago, and this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. Fourth quarter about to get underway here from Millett Hall tonight. Miami 59, Loyola Chicago 35. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland back with you courtside from Millett Hall this evening with the RedHawks He's got to keep on pushing.
I think the word out of that timeout had to have been finish. Right?
Yeah.
Played great so far in the last three quarters. Finish it here in the fourth and get some positive momentum for the rest of the season.
Murdoch team tonight trying to stop their three-game losing streak. They're 1-1 on this home floor this season. So top the key with the basketball here is Ivy Wolf to the far wing for Claire Chambers. Left wing outside the arc. Chambers holds it above her head. Far side, well, no, top the key. They went to Maddie Kloos. And she sinks a three ball to start out the fourth quarter, 62-35 Redhawks.
Miami shot about 50% from three. I mean, that's a really a great formula if they can find a way to keep that going in the next couple games.
52.9% for three-point land tonight, 51.1% for the field for the Redhawks.
Yeah, they've shot the lights out tonight. It's been fantastic.
Top of the key with a Chandler down the middle of the paint and will float it off the window for two with the right arm, and the Redhawks kind of breaking down defensively there in the end of the floor that they guard. So here come Miami with the ball over the timeline of the right wing. It's Maddie Kloos with it for the Redhawks. First side for Ivy Wolf, holds it above her head with 15 to shoot. Near wing with it, here's Maddie Kloos. Down the right side of the paint, will flip it with a right arm over the hoop. That was kind of a bad angled shot. Redhawks will defend now as Loyola Chicago up the floor on the right wing, and a good play. Near side pass to Chandler that came from Chivers, who drove away up the right side. And as Chandler finished off the window with both arms, good for 2 points, 62-39 Miami. Near wing with the ball is Chambers for Miami. Goes top to Key Freeman. 90 seconds gone by in the fourth quarter. Wolf, left side of the paint, will his foot, that one straight up in the air under the hoop and went back to the Ramblers. Here's Chivers on the timeline right wing, drives her way to the rim. A little bit too far left in the layup attempt there. It came down. Redhawks trying to fight for the rebound. Loyola Chicago had a hand on it, and they will get it. A jump ball whistled here is landing on the football fumble style play. There was Anna Brown, tied up by Ivy Wolf. The jump ball possession arrow is with Loyola Chicago. They're going to get it here in their offensive end near side of the baseline with 8:10 to go in the fourth.
Yeah, it looks like Ivy Wolf's going to the bench. She's been in the game for a long period of time. I think if you're Maddie Kloos and Ivy Wolf, you know, those are a couple wild possessions. You know, just go back to running the offense and just keep doing the right things there. Because Loyola's getting some fast break opportunities where they can score quick.
Chivers will inbound here for Loyola Chicago on the near wing of the baseline. Gets it up top of the key. Tannen's with it. Right side of the elbow, the right-handed dribble. Will just shoot one up, and it's good from the right elbow by Tannen. So Tannen now has 7 points in the game tonight. Point leader is Chandler for Loyola Chicago with 11. She averages 13.5 a game this year. Top of the key, Redhawks on offense. Near wing feed to Richardson. Down low right side of the paint. Morrow floats it up. She's fouled. It was short and fell over. The whistle here on the foul for Sophia Nolan. Made some contact there. Go ahead.
No, I just was going to say, Patrick, I think, you know, if you're Coach Hendricks, too, you know, we're talking about building block games, getting momentum. You know, this is also where you can really develop good habits, right? You know, you have a 21-point lead. Make sure you keep doing the right things you've done in the first three quarters in this fourth quarter here. Finish strong.
That's a good point. Morrow's first free throw is short there for the Redhawks. Next one will come through. That is good. 63-41 Miami over Loyola Chicago. On the top line of the right wing is Chivers. Goes top of the key with it is Anna Brown around the right side of the paint. Will hit the brakes, float it back right side of the paint. There was Chivers. Got to know outside the arc. Down low to the free throw line for Tannen. Right side of the paint, she's got it. And will put it in for 2 points there with both arms. Little floater on the right side, and the Redhawks take this one over the timeline here on the middle area of the floor as Peyton Scott is with it. 63-43, the lead back to 20 for Miami. Go ahead.
No, great defense by Katie Richardson. Just better offense there on that play. You know, that's just tough.
To the rack was Kloos. She was fouled. And as a whistle came through, she kind of floated it off the glass, and then the shot never went through. Chandler whistled for the foul, and a good drive up the right wing by Kloos to get to the rack. In for Loyola Chicago is done. Brown is out. Free throw at the line for Kloos coming up. She'll shoot two.
Yeah, Miami's done a lot of great things so far in this game. The one thing that maybe can get better is free throw shooting. Only shooting 61% of the line.
Yeah, that's true. First one good there by Klus. Next one missed too far left, and some of these close conference games down the line, that's what's going to decide it. Good point. Chivers up the left wing, coast to coast. Took the free throw rebound and put it in for two with the right arm. Beat everybody back the floor for the RedHawks. 64-45, Miami with the lead.
Yeah, I think Coach Andrews is going to be a little upset with that, the transition defense right now. It's been a strong point in the first three quarters, but here they're kind of struggling to get back on defense. That's just an intensity thing. That's just a hard thing. You got to really fight back in transition because the half-court defense has been tremendous so far.
Right. Mara lifts the ball, their right arm off the glass. Too hard. The ball went out of bounds back to Little Chicago. It goes on the offensive chance for the RedHawks. 6:37 to go in the fourth quarter. Over the timeline right wing is Gallinopoulos. Top of the key with it is Whitney Dunn for Loyola Chicago. Back to the right elbow for Tannen. Off the window, too much. RedHawks to the rebound. It's Klus over the timeline here on the left wing. Matty Klus to the left-handed dribble. Hands it off there for Ivy Wolf. Outside the arc on the left side. Back for Richardson. Inside the arc. Morrow with the ball. She lost it. Kind of bobble the feed. Here come the Ramblers. Chandler over the timeline right wing. Gallinopoulos with it at the right elbow. Dishes back here. Dunn, three ball, too much on it. Rebound grabbed by Tannen. On the right elbow with it. We'll dish back for a three-pointer here. Too much on that from Chandler. The rebound there to Ivy Wolf. Over the timeline, middle of the floor for the RedHawks. Shield fired off the glass, coast to coast short. But a foul is whistled on the defender back. That was Whitney Dunn with 5:50 left here in the fourth. And that will send to the line Ivy Wolf here for a pair of free throws with Miami up 64-45.
It seemed like whether it was going to be Tannen or Nolan tonight, it seemed like Loyola Chicago really wanted to get the ball inside with those two, and they've continued to keep going to them. They're shooting threes a lot now, which is not doesn't seem like much of their game.
First free throw is too hard by Ivy Wolf. Free throw shooter at 95% this season. Next one is good as well from Ivy Wolf. A little bit short, then it kind of popped over the rim and in. 5:45 to go in the fourth. 20-point RedHawk lead. Down through the paint comes Tannen with a jumper that's good from the left side of the paint. And the RedHawks here will march their way back up the floor in a 65-47 game led by Miami. Loose over the timeline, middle of the floor for the RedHawks with a left-handed dribble. Marks their way around the arc to the far wing there for Watkins. Sydney Watkins puts it down low, left side of the paint. Here's Wolf on the right-handed shot, short off the iron, little hook shot there. Rebound though pops out, and Klus is on it for the RedHawks outside the arc. Cross-court feed on the left wing. Here's Wolf back near wing. Klus with a three-pointer. That one missed too far right. Rebound is corralled by the Ramblers, and they lost it. It's going to stay with the RedHawks. Is getting her hand on that was Tannen and tipped it out of bounds near the RedHawk bench. And it's going to stay with Miami as we have a timeout, I believe, with 5:04 left in the fourth quarter. Miami 65, Loyola Chicago 47 here from inside Millett Hall. And this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. We'll be right back. 5:04 to go here in the fourth quarter. Miami 65, Loyola Chicago 47. Patrick Geshan, Patrick Holland back with you inside Millett Hall here tonight. Andrew Relva says the postgame show coming up. What can we expect on that, Andrew?
Yeah, I'm going to break it down for all you. It's going to be a fun one, no question about it. Let's see if the RedHawks can hang on and get this much-needed win here at Millett Hall.
It'll be their second home win of the season if they can do it. 65-47, the lead with 5:04 to go in this fourth quarter. As we will wrap this one up here from inside Millett Hall tonight.
I think that was a smart timeout by Coach Hendricks, particularly. You could kind of see like a little bit of fatigue was setting in there. You weren't getting the same looks from Wolf and Klaus close there. So I think it was smart to just take a timeout, regroup, and just finish this game off strong like you're talking about.
Yeah.
Because they have played fantastic so far. You don't want to, like I said, you want to develop good habits in moments like this, right?
It's a good point. And this is where they were going to count. So there is three timeouts for Miami, two for Loyola Chicago in the game so far. There's no fouls yet as a team from the RedHawks in its fourth quarter. Loyola Chicago has three fouls as a team in the fourth so far. The inbound will come from the RedHawks, far side of their sideline, as Matty Kluse sends it in top of the key for Ivy Wolf. The right-handed dribble to the near wing for Sydney Watkins. Right wing with it outside the arc, Amani Freeman. Left wing, Watkins. The jumper's good. That is two. She was right on the line. 4:50 left here in the fourth quarter. 20-point Red Hawk lead. Chivers with it, top the key. Here's Anna Dunn with the ball, right side of the paint. Ran it to Red Hawk player there. That's a blocking foul on Ivy Wolf, who fell over. 4:42 to go in the fourth quarter. 67-47 Miami. And they get a inbound coming here, far side of the baseline for Loyola Chicago in their offensive end. It's Chandler.
Yeah, Ivy Wolf's got to be kind of careful here. She's up to four. You know, she's getting a little bit of danger zone. Keep playing tough defense, but you're getting a little close.
Chivers with it, right side of the elbow. This is far away for Whitney Dunn. Through the free throw line area, left wing. She knocked over a Red Hawk player. That's a charge. Knocked over Watkins. The shot went in, but it will not count. On a late call there by the official. Whitney Dunn with the foul for her third, and with 4:31 to go on the fourth, 67-47, Miami with the ball back up by 20.
That's a winning charge taken by Sydney Watkins. Sydney Watkins right there.
Under the hoop.
Yep.
Close with the ball to the timeline here on the right wing. We'll go back up top to Key with it with a right-handed dribble. Round the arc in the near wing, flip it near wing for Wolf. Right side of the paint, Morrow will float it up, a little bit too far left on the rim. Rebound here to Gallinopoulos for Loyola Chicago. Hits the brakes near side, outside the arc. Top of the key with it is Brown. Favorite part was Dunn. Now near wing, Chandler. Right elbow, Dunn. Down low, trying to feed Tanning. Get tipped away by the RedHawks. On the timeline, left wing is Watkins for Miami. Top of the key with it here is Amani Freeman. Holds it above her head with both arms. Close, near side. Three is good. Nothing but net, Matty Kluse. And a whistle here with 3:47 left. I think a foul was called afterward on the RedHawks. The bucket's going to count, but I think there you get Morrow for a foul that came right after the bucket went through. 70-47, that grows the RedHawk lead with 3:47 to go in the fourth. Going to have the inbound here from Loyola Chicago. Brown sends it in for Gallinopoulos. Over the timeline on the right wing, back for Brown, top of the key. Right elbow drives her way down the right side of the paint, off the window for two, it's good. Kluse floats it forward for Ivy Wolf with 3.5 to go in the fourth. Wolf over the timeline here on the right wing. Gets top of the key, far wing now with it is Cindy Watkins. Top of the key, Wolf, the ball kind of tipped away from her, she got it back. Watkins back with it, left elbow, and a travel call here against Sydney Watkins. Took a step too many trying to drive away toward the hoop with 3:17 to go in the fourth quarter.
This fourth quarter has been a little bit sloppy on both ends. Just kind of, it seems like fatigue has kind of set in for both teams. You know, a little bit sloppier, a little bit more fouls as we've seen in the last couple minutes.
Brown top of the key is fouled there by Watkins. Oh, very important, it's Kluse number one. Got in there with some contact. That'll be the third team foul against Miami in the fourth quarter. She's going to have the inbound come here from Anna Brown of Loyola Chicago. Top of the key for Gallinopoulos. Left wing is Chandler outside the paint. She'll try to float a centering feed through, but it was picked off by Kloos of the RedHawks on the timeline here on the right wing. Kloos left-handed dribble goes top of the key for Morrow. Near wing outside the arc is Ivy Wolf with the ball for the RedHawks. Left wing Kloos outside the arc. Trying to float a pass down low, tipped off a Rambler handed out. The baseline, Galanopoulos tipped it away from the intended target in Freeman. You're going to have Kloos come out of the game. And it looks like to take her place, Riley Neal for the RedHawks.
She had a great 35 minutes, gave a ton of points. Excellent effort by Maddie Kloos.
Far side, a little inbound here on the paint area. Those Watkins, the right-handed shot was too hard that she got her own rebound. Put it back through. Over the timeline on the right wing, Galanopoulos. Top the key with it. Here is Tannen to the left wing, Chandler. 2.5 to go in the fourth quarter. RedHawks lead 72-49. Chandler a step back from the right elbow. Dribbled in and out off the rim. RedHawks up ahead. Left wing feed Watkins over the timeline. Now near wing, Wolf a three. And guess what? It's good for Ivy Wolf, who now has 27 points on the night tonight.
I would say in those type of possessions, I'd like to see maybe five or more passes, maybe more methodical possessions with the ball, but the way Ivy Wolf shooting, just let her have it.
Just let her have it. Shot the other end by Tannen, too hard. Wolf gets it back over the timeline, right wing Watkins with two to go in the fourth quarter. 75-49, Miami is top the key with the basketball is Ivy Wolf. Here wing for Riley Neal. Outside the arc, 12 to shoot. Holds it above her head and delays. Top of the key now, Freeman. Far side with it is Ivy Wolf. Bounce past Freeman. Left side of the paint working. Left-handed shot off the window too much. Rebound corralled by Loyola Chicago. Tannen will feed up ahead to Galanopoulos over the timeline on the right wing. Feeds it back on the far side. Near wing is Tannen now. Outside the arc, 20 to shoot. Drives her way right side of the paint. Right-handed shot off the glass too much. A little bit too far right as well. Rebound Miami was initially grabbed by Freeman, and now it's on to Ivy Wolf. Over the timeline on the floor is Wolf. Around the arc here on the left side of the paint. Dishes back for Morrow. Win the ball for the RedHawks. Morrow will float it through the netting, and she was no good on the shot. But she was fouled, a lot of contact that knocked her off. And with 1:07 to go in the fourth quarter, we will get two shots to the line here for Sierra Morrow.
I think if you look at the stat sheet of this game, you didn't watch it or anything, you'll say to yourself, oh, Ivy Wolf played great. Maddie Kloos played great. And they did. They respectfully had a really great game. But I think this is a team win for the RedHawks, right? I think everybody put in a great effort tonight, fought for loose balls, fought for extra rebounds. I mean, they played a really tremendous game. And this is something you could say if you're Coach Hendricks. This is a great team effort. All right, this is not – a couple players played outstanding, but you had a great team effort overall.
I agree. It's been a really strong performance, all facets tonight. You mentioned a few of the weaknesses, but those can easily be cleaned up.
Right.
You're not going to play a perfect game ever. Morrow made the second free throw, 77-49 Miami. The red carpet rolled out, a drive for the far corner of the hoop by Maddie Scarborough of Loyola Chicago, who's appeared now in three straight for the Ramblers, goes in for two. Jesse Dye has the ball now for the RedHawks with 50 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, top of the key. Shovels a feed to the near wing for Claire Chambers. Gets it to the right side of the paint. Freeman kicks back out. Chambers triple too much on it. Top of the key. RedHawks get it back out on the offensive rebound. Dye is with it at the big red M at half court to the near wing for Chambers. Right side of the paint. Freeman shoots. It's good. Just off the edge of the paint line there. 79-51 Miami with 25 to go in the fourth quarter. Top of the key with it here is Tannen. Dishes back outside the arc of the far wing from Scarborough. Tannen, baseline, right side of the paint, off the window. It's good for two for Loyola Chicago. 13 seconds to go. Dye with the ball for Miami over the timeline on the right wing. Guarded there by Galanopoulos. And Dye just going to dribble this one out near half court of the big red M with a second to go. And that'll do it here from Millett Hall tonight. Miami 79, Loyola Chicago 53, your final score tonight. The RedHawks started with the gas pedal to the metal, and they never really let up all night long. Really good team-oriented win for Miami on their home floor tonight.
I think, you know, like we said, Patrick, midway through the first quarter, we're talking about that gas pedal, keeping your foot on the pedal all throughout the game. And it wasn't going to, you know, in that first quarter, this Loyola Chicago team wasn't going to lie down. It wasn't going to be something you could earn in the first 10 minutes. This had to be a four-quarter effort, and they did that. you know, towards the end there, you got a little bit sloppy, you know, some offensive possession, you like that.
Right.
But overall, this is something you can work with, right? Like I said, you had great efforts from individuals like Close, like Ivy Wolf. But throughout the team, I mean, I saw tremendous effort all throughout. And this is something, like we were talking about, a building block type game, something you can say. You know, we had a couple rough games here. We shook it off, we came back, we played a great game tonight against a pretty good Loyola Chicago team.
79-53, the final. RedHawks improved to 2-4 overall. They are yet to play a MAC game, of course, but that's a really good performance to think about when you start thinking about league play, which is coming up soon, that the RedHawks can really kind of think back on, glean on in terms of positive stuff, the confidence level as they move forward. Loyola Chicago now falls to 2-5. They are 1-3 now on the road, but overall, RedHawks team with a great job tonight.
Yeah, I think like we've been talking about, you know, the one thing they can maybe clean up is free throw. You know, you shot 63% for the free throw line. We talked about it a little earlier. In conference games, when you get really tight, you're going to look back at that and say, you know, we needed to make some more from the free throw line. But outside of that, I mean, that's practice. That's a couple extra half an hour, extra 45 minutes shooting free throws. But the rest of the stuff, I mean, the shooting was fantastic. Over 52% from the three-point percentage. I mean, a lot of this stuff is, you know, really great efforts from, you know, not just one or two people, from the whole team. And really a lot of great efforts you can see from Coach Hendricks and stuff you can build with.
Yeah, that's a good point. And a 79-53 win for the RedHawks. Good job, Patrick, as always.
You as well.
It was fun. As Patrick Holland, Patrick Geshan signing off for the game tonight. Andrew Relvas will take you the rest of the way with the post-game show. Andrew, go ahead.
Thank you so much, Patrick. Yes, the RedHawks finally winning it once again. The record improves now to 2-4 overall, 2-1 at home. So great win at home against a very scrappy, very energetic Loyola Chicago team who we really saw play press defense. They were in-your-face defense, and Miami getting it done big after a 25-point loss against Evansville on the road. So great way to turn it around, especially in front of the Miami faithful, really doing a great job. Really, the storyless game has been the three-point shooting for the RedHawks. They made 11 threes on the day, six coming from Ivy Wolf, who has a season-high 27 points, shooting a 10 for 20 from the field, 6 for 10 from three, and overall played extremely well. 36 minutes tonight, so she really never got any break, and that really doesn't matter because Ivy Wolf is a different type of player, different breed of player, played extremely well, 27 points, season high. Have yourself a game, Ivy Wolf. Great game for the RedHawks. Now for RedHawks, they were in double figures. That was Peyton Scott, Ivy Wolf, of course. Morrow as well, Sierra Morrow, and Maddie Kloos. All four of them were in double figures. If you have four players who are in double figures, you're in a pretty good spot, pretty good position to win the game, and the RedHawks absolutely did that. They played their hearts out. They out-rebounded them. They got out-rebounded by 17 last game against Evansville, and they out-rebounded the Ramblers of Loyola by 7 tonight. So overall, playing a good game, very physical game against a very physical team, and they got it done. They limited the Ramblers of Chicago to 15% from three-point land. That's pretty good if you ask me. Played extremely well against a scrappy team like them, and really limiting the Ramblers to 39% from the field. So it's okay, but they did good there. And Loyola shot 9 for 11 from the free throw line. They're a great free throw shooting team, and overall played a pretty good game. Maya Chandler, 11 points on the day, and Tannen had 13 points as well, 8 rebounds on the day, so almost a double-double for her. But overall, RedHawks played extremely well down the stretch, had a scorching hot first half, and kind of cooled down for them in the second half, but they were up by a ton, which really was the story of the day. So Miami, again, a much-needed win at home here at Millett Hall, 79-53, 26-point win. That's pretty sweet if you ask me. Any basketball fan loves a blowout win, and the RedHawks do just that. Really, their defense, like a boa constrictor, giving no hope to the opponent, really suffocating them, 15%. That will be a storyline for Coach Deanna Hendricks in the locker room, no question about it. Now for the RedHawks, their next game is versus the Eastern Kentucky Lady Colonels, Lady Colonels in the first game of the I-75 Challenge. That game is on Friday, December 2nd at 7 p.m. here at Millett Hall. So that game will be on RedHawk Radio. And for the Loyola Ramblers, their next game is versus the UIC Flames on Thursday, December 1st at 7 p.m. Central at the Gentile Arena. So Loyola Chicago losing their first five out of six games, trying to get another win. We'll see if they can do it against the UIC Flames. And the RedHawks playing against the Eastern Kentucky Lady Colonels. That'll be a fun one for sure. Just like that, Miami enjoying a big win on a Monday night right after Thanksgiving break. So did everything well all across the board. Feels great. RedHawks feel great. Just like that, Miami blows out the Ramblers of Loyola by 26 points. Thanks so much for tuning in to another edition of Miami Women's Basketball here on RedHawk Radio. I'm Andrew Relvas. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and I hope you all have a great rest of your night and stay safe, everyone. Thanks, guys.
I figured it was muted at this point.
Right?
Yeah.
Congratulations. Nice work. Right. That's the head coach of the Miami RedHawks. RedHawks wrap up in just a moment.
How about it? You got both of them?
Okay.
How about it?
Thanks.
Did that look familiar? That look more familiar? Oh, okay. Ask her what I told her today.
It was great once we got
here. I heard about that too.
I'm just going to leave it.
Sid, nice to have you back.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Leave it here for Terry tomorrow night?
Yeah. I'm done with it.
I'll see you Friday.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, bye.
She makes us better.
taking a look at the individual scoring in this one, as Coach said, four in double figures tonight for the RedHawks, led by Ivy Wolf with 27 points. That is a season high, and you can mark down six threes in this game, 6 out of 10 from behind the arc, and 10 out of 20 for Wolf tonight. 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and 4 big steals. Remember, she had 6 steals against Xavier earlier this year, so she has played some solid defense as well. The RedHawks also got 15 points from Batty Close on 4 field goals, 2 of those 3s, 5 out of 8 at the free throw line, 8 rebounds, 5 assists, which is a season high, and 2 steals for Batty Close, 15 points. 13 for Peyton Scott in just 15 minutes. 5 out of 10 from the field, 2 threes, 1 out of 1 at the free throw line, 3 rebounds, and also 4 assists. Tonight, and a couple of steals. Scott, I can honestly tell you, that looks like a bigger Scott. Yeah, full game, and she's more energy. Snowmore with 11 points and 7 rebounds. A nice night for her, 29 minutes, 3 out of 5 from the field, 3 out of 5 out of 6 from the free throw line, and Sierra Moore. Others said the Watkins goes for 6 points and 2 assists and 2 steals. And her return, 2 points for Riley Neal and 3 rebounds tonight for her. She went on 2 field and a good night for Riley Neal off the bench.
Not a cow.
For the Loyola Ramblers, they finished with 53 points, and Satori Tedder with 13 of them. Geshan finished with 11, she's their leading scorer, and a couple of points below her average. Just 2 in double figures tonight for the Ramblers. Sophia Miller found out again with 9 points, 7 for Sam Galanopoulos. Galanopoulos finished with just 1 assist, and she was averaging 4 assists a game for her. 5 for Anna Brown, and 2 each for Kira Shivers, and 2 for Mallory Remage, and Maddie Strasburg also has 2 points a game. Come back to the let's see, the smart player of the game, and team stats, and the scoreboard, all that on the way. 79-53 win by the RedHawks over Loyola. This is the Miami Sports Network, driven by Performance Hunter and Performance Toyota.
field for 35 minutes tonight. 10 out of 20 from the field. Six threes, that is a new career high for her. One out of two at the free throw line, five rebounds, three assists, four steals. And 35 minutes. She played hard. And she is our smart player of the game. Brought to you by TicketSmart, the best place to find tickets to live sports, concerts, and live events near you. Visit TicketSmart.com or download the app to secure your tickets. Team stats look like this. Miami 28 out of 60 from the floor. They had seven more shots and seven more field goals. Threes out of 21 attempts, 52.6 is the number. And that is impressive. The free throw line, 63.7. All right, where does that stand? 11 made threes. Well, the Redhawks really shot the threes on the left forward in the history. And that is not in the top 10. The highest is back. As far as the other stats are concerned, Miami plus seven on the boards, 37-30, 19 assists. 13 turnovers and 11 steals in the basketball game. 26 points off turnovers and 26 points for Bane. A 21 fast break. As well. Home the Ramblers to 21 out of 53 from the field. 39.6%. Just two threes today for the Ramblers. So that's a plus nine. And they were limited to just 11 free throw attempts, and they had 9 of those for 82%. 6 assists, 19 turnovers, and 8 steals. Checking the Pepsi Sports update for you, and a couple of games involving other Mid-American Conference teams. Looking at the MAC, pull up the scores, and it was Bowling Green, which was 76-29. And Akron survives at Northern Kentucky, beating the Norris 70-69. It's a big win for the Zips. They are the bottom basketball team. And looking at one other score, Wright State is Eastern Illinois. Should have gone final. Let's see, they did. And Eastern Illinois beat Wright State 96-67. So those are men's scores, women's scores tonight. We will wrap it up. I think we've taken care of the business today. As four players scoring double figures for Miami. And for the second time here at the Red Hawks. We'll get another crack at it on Friday night as they take on Eastern. Final score, Miami 79 and Loyola Chicago 53. We'll come up on Friday night.
Yeah, buses. That right.
And 7 o'clock tip.